Welcome, everybody. I want to say a special welcome to the Live Wires, the Lime Wires, the Ladies with Bucks, the Beta Cucks. It's episode 225 Nerd Rage Radio.
It's Nerd Rage After Dark.
It is.
I wanted to say a couple things for one. I am aware. Well, let me say this to the listeners. I want to give a special shout out and invitation. If any of you would like to be my friend and have little get togethers and have me over, if I'm in driving distance, I will come, because BroFest 2 went down, you know, without a hitch. It looked like great fun. There was party accents on the picture. That's how you know they kept it a buck.
It took me a lot longer than it should have to pick out pick out the confetti.
But before we get into the fun shit, there's one thing I want to get out of the way straight away. And that is my emotional tantrum last week. And I got a lot of feedback on it, positive and negative, which was to be expected. I kind of knew the vibes when I did it, or after I did it. One thing that was nice about it, when I listened back to it, is, Chris, I got to give you a special slow clap. He brought me out of it quick as fuck, and he did it with a song. But it took me right out of it, put me right back in my bag. This is the thing I want to say about it. There were people that commented, some of which even threatened to put hands on me, for lack of a better term, which is fine. But I want to make it clear that I'm speaking about the extremes, right? When I talk about that stuff, I'm talking about the extremes. That's an extreme segment of population that feels that way. Mm-hmm. Now, if you feel that way,
that's you.
That's you. The shoe, lace that shoe up. You earned it. It's the weekend. Put it on. Go dancing. The same is true on the other side, right? Like the don't spread your legs too far in the subway. You're man spreading. Like, shut the fuck up. But the energy is consistent.
On both ends, yeah.
I'm not doing that. You know why I'm not doing that, Joseph? Because I'm a fucking man. And it's comfortable to sit with my legs spread in the metro. So I'm going to sit with my legs spread. If it offends you, then I'm sorry. But see, what we have to realize is that these extremes, while they are the most heard, they don't represent the lot of us.
The majority.
Correct. Like, I get as fed up with that shit. You know, I just saw, like, Ben Shapiro and fucking Jordan Peterson, or whatever the fuck that asshole's name is, do a random speech about how Frozen is trying to make a statement about the male patriarchy.
What?
Like, shut up. You know, like, I'm not applying all that shit to my children's cartoons and to my fun. I'm in it. I'm in it for the lulls. I'm in it for the lore. I'm in it for the mythology.
And the arguments.
And I like a little argument here and there. I like a little argument here and
there. Just a little sauce.
So, I got to tell you guys, it's very stressful this week. It's very stressful.
Yeah.
Because Joe and Chris came in at about the same time. So, I didn't know.
He came in front door, I came in the back door at the exact same time.
A Chinese finger cuffed my house.
Well, half of us is Chinese finger cuffed.
That's true. I actually...
but you can... Can you teach that, though?
Do you know...
Please say a random Asian person, and you're asking if he knows this person.
Do you know this girl, Krista? No, there was some basketball shit not too long ago. Like, I guess it spawned from the LeBron thing.
Mm.
But somebody else made some... I think it was the Rockets owner made some statement like, Hong Kong, we are with you.
Mm. So it was Steve Kerr, who's the coach of the Golden State Warriors, I do believe.
Okay.
Wow, it's maybe not Rockets at all.
Maybe it was the Rockets people that stepped in. The Rockets are involved in somehow. Maybe
Rockets are involved because of Yao Ming. So Yao Ming is Chinese.
Yeah, dude, I know what you mean. What?
Yep, so Yao Ming. has been an NBA ambassador since he retired because he's huge and gets hurt a lot. And that's why the Rockets are heavily involved in the Chinese market.
Well, yes. So apparently the NBA has a huge stake in the Chinese market.
Everybody does.
So they,
is it like Porterhouse?
Yes. So they stepped in and they said, look, we're not getting, we're not picking a side. We're not, when there's, when, with this situation, I feel like, I mean, and maybe I'm biased. I'm biased. But I do feel like there's a clear right and wrong here. Like, so for them to be like, we're not picking a side is like, oh, you are picking a side.
It's picking a side with your wallet. Well, yeah, they're voting with
the
wallet.
But they're picking the green side.
Why the Rockets didn't have to change the names and the Bullets did?
Because the Rockets Red Glare. Yao Ming.
We used to be the Bullets, didn't we, somewhere around here?
Yeah, we were the Bullets. Baltimore Bullets.
Yeah, it makes sense. Yeah.
The Wizards.
The fucking Wizards.
Yeah, that's trash.
But yet we still have the Redskins.
I tell you what, though, the Baltimore Bullets hat pops up every now and then. Like, you know, like in circulation.
I think I still have some shorts somewhere.
Yeah, it's good. So
who would win? A Bullet or a Wizard?
A Wizard.
Are you sure? Gandalf old as fuck. I bet you I can shoot him.
I don't think so.
Before he can put a shield
he
up?
He took down a lava monster with wings.
Yeah, but that guy's slow. He saw it coming.
But he had a whip made of fire.
And he got him.
Yeah, but Gandalf got him, too.
All right. Listeners, we need a hard answer. Who wins in this?
A Bullet or a Wizard?
Well, who's shooting the gun though? Is it John Wick?
I was gonna say somebody's gonna fucking say Keanu Reeves.
Nicholas is shooting.
Let's get somebody. Let's get Viggo Mortensen plays.
Well, so Gandalf is like one of a top wizard, right?
Right.
So you gotta get a top shooter.
He's on the extremes. Yeah.
So it's like the rabbit guy, the brown wizard. He's definitely getting shot.
The brown one.
The guy with the...
Yeah, what was his name?
Rabbit fucking chariot.
Raga. Shit.
Raga shit.
Raga muffin. Let's see if Siri... Hey, Siri, what's the name of the brown wizard from The Hobbit?
Here's what I found.
Radagast.
Radagast. Yeah, because like, he's definitely not dodging a bullet.
He's pretty cool in a movie, though. He's one of my favorite characters in that movie because he's just got bird shit all over his face and beard and he just rolls up and with a sled rabbit. Of rabbits.
I mean, he's in the Lord of the Rings books, too, but they cut him out for the movie.
Yeah.
Character development, man.
Fluff.
Fluffy bunnies.
So, Chris came into my home from the front door and Joe came into the back door.
Of course, I was coming to the back door.
Mm-hmm.
favorite door.
At the same time. So I made Chris his cup of coffee first, and to play it fair, I will have Joe go first on Nerd Weeks. How was your Nerd Week, sir?
Hey, have you guys been? I didn't realize like that we had YouTube watcher/listeners till recently when you told me. Oh, people do watch on YouTube other than me.
Yeah, the numbers like I think we do like 200 to 300 on YouTube, and then the audio platform is where we do most of our numbers,
and then. So I always listen every week, but I didn't realize other people were listening. So since I realized other people were listening, I was like, oh, let me look at the comment section. It's a terrible idea, as always. It's fucking never a good idea to look at comment section on anything internet related.
Mm-hmm. But you get numb to it after a while, Joe, if it makes you feel any better. I've gotten some really bad ones recently. But I did get a little peace of mind recently. Shout out to the Patreon folks. I did a wine and cheese and put that out on Monday. And I had a sensitive question. It was a dangerous question because it would have been a war. But there was some shit brewing that I had to ask.
Mm.
And the Patreon listeners like hit me up like, nah, like I've never I consume content over from there. I've never heard anything. But I was getting some clues that I might have to put them hawks on you.
Big 38, go hawk them.
Jesus.
But yeah, how was your nerd week? Talk to me about your nerd week. What Star Wars stuff did you watch?
Rebels.
How are you? How are you doing?
No, I enjoyed it. Okay. Quite enjoying
Still
it.
Still in season one?
I think so. All right. I've been busy. It's been a busy week. It's been stressful. So yesterday on my way to work in Baltimore, I got a call from corporate. Say, can you divert to St. Mary's? Someone called out. I was like, I won't get there till 10. He's like, that's fine. We need somebody there. So I had to turn around and drive fucking 2.5 hours down that way.
But they paid you from...
They paid me from the moment they called.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then so I didn't get home till fucking 9:30 last night. Ate dinner, went to bed, went directly back to work this morning. got off work and came directly here after work. And then tonight I have to go down to Chevy Chase to my parents so I can work there tomorrow morning.
Hmm.
But then I'm off Thursday. Dude, I serendipitous? You know,
I love that word, by the way. You know I do.
I like the movie.
Trash.
It's good.
Come on.
It's a good
movie. It's a good movie.
I don't think I even like the people that are in it.
Kate Beckinsdale is in it. She's
no, I think I find her trash. I think I find her irritating
she's
as well.
Hot.
I think I find her irritating as well, but I think that's
I
a
think
good
she's
movie.
Hot.
I think it's a good movie.
And who else is in it?
Doesn't.
Who's the guy?
I don't know. Hugh Grant. Who cares? Move on.
You know, real quick, I hate to cut you off, and I'm going to let you finish. My buddy Andy, that's helping me with the Force Friday stuff,
mm-hmm.
He's a young lad.
Okay.
And I don't know if you've seen Rose on the red carpet. Did you catch that?
No, I purposely have avoided everything.
Rose let them comments get to her. Because Rose is out here looking like she's ready to kill the Graham.
Oh, let me look
at it's not the same Rose. It's a different Rose. It's her.
What's her? What do you know her name? Whether that's
she's
name.
She's living her best life now.
Good.
Yeah.
Good for her.
Yeah. So I don't. Kelly Marie Tran.
All right.
So she. So Andy sends me this text message. And I probably shouldn't even be putting out this because it was private. He was like, "Hey man, I'll be honest with you. I'd hit." So I was like, "Look, look here, young lad." I mean, I was like, it's cute that you, but that when you become a man, you'll realize there's certain things you don't even have to say. That's of course, that's light.
It's just,
no, but yeah, but same, she's from? In the same ballpark. That's the same era.
Okay.
Let me see if I can find it. But, she shed the hate. And she shed the weight. You know what I'm saying? Yao Ming?
Yeah.
Yao Ming. My goodness.
It's big and tall. Your people.
Come on, Mac.
No, I'm looking at the same thing right
Come
now.
Come on, Mac.
Good for her. Good for her. Now, listen. The role she plays is...
I like her... I like her attitude, but...
She's out here now. She's outside now. She's outside.
I mean, the role she plays is she's kind of a dumpy, frumpy character.
Yeah, it's supposed to be.
And that's supposed to be, you know?
Not my bag.
Not everybody.
I can see why people like it.
So I told him, I was like, look, man, I'm going to have to be the Han to your Luke. That's light work, boy. but yeah, she's looking great. Let's make some noise for her. She's looking great.
Live your life.
Yeah. But side note, while I'm on the topic... So we did the Kathy Kennedy shit. I'm over. I've said everything I had to say about that. I'm good. But, you know, then we did the Trandoshans this past week.
Yes.
And then I got something else.
That's good.
Thank you. I got something else lined up that's going to be, I think, fun. It's going to be fun and interesting and entertaining. And I shot it to him, and he was like, yeah, I knew you'd get here soon. I knew you'd get here soon. Like, I've been kind of tracking the trajectory of where you've been going. I knew you'd get here soon. It's a good, let him breathe for a minute. But he's like, he's on the same page. You know what I mean? Like, he knows, like, sometimes we got to go in and hammer, and then we let off, and then we're like, look, and remember this, and this is great too, and this is good, and this is cool. This is something you hadn't thought about, and then I got to hammer, you know, to try to break it down, build you up. It's my
change up the pace, man.
Yep.
Can I'm get used to it?
So continue. I'm sorry.
Oh, serendipitous.
Yes.
God, what a still good movie. I gotta watch it again.
You don't think it's a good movie?
When she finds a book with this, when he finds a book with a signature at the end,
it's trash, guys. Come on. Listen, as someone that worked in the video industry for almost
an expert.
For almost an expert in our almost case. A decade.
Yeah.
No, it's I just
really
there's so many movies that are just I don't know. It had a little bit of a
do you think this is the beginning of the end of Brofest? Is this the first big disagreement you guys have had?
Well, over which movie we're gonna watch? Yeah. Sorry. I don't have it downloaded and I don't have a DVD player.
How
like,
about
like Gramps over here? So
oh, let's take a bet. Because shout out to listeners, spoilers, Marilyn Phil is en route.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Backwards or down?
Uh-huh.
I'm thinking it's back.
I think it's back. Back. I think it's gonna hit.
I think if it wasn't back today, it's gonna be back by the time it gets.
It's gotta be. Because here's the thing. We're talking about his hair.
No hat. I'm assuming
he's
hat.
Coming straight from work.
I'm I'm going to say
he has hat in his car.
Yeah, I'm going to say hat. I'm going to say hat. And then at some point, he's gonna doff that motherfucker. And it's going to be slick back. Because in that one group chat, like, you know, I said it here in person. I was like, look, I'm man enough to tell you. You look fucking good, you know, with it back.
Yeah.
You know?
Sure. And then, better, for
and,
sure.
Yeah, for sure. And then in the chat, Sherelle was like, look at Phil out here with the, you know, so yep. Like, you know, that should have been the sign.
I mean,
like,
I think it's unanimous. Everyone thinks it's better. It's like a big difference.
So let's see. Let's see how it goes. Okay, okay.
And then who's going to listen back and be like, oh, he's talking shit about me.
Is it? Look, if we felt weird about it, we'd cut it out. Do you know what I mean? If it's in here, it means it's all in love.
We never cut anything out.
We've cut some things
99.9%
of the time. We've cut some things you've said out, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There's a couple things this year that we've cut. There's one thing in particular that springs to my mind. Like a slinky. Like it's very wound up. Continue.
You're trying to talk about this movie.
No.
Saren.
No, yeah. Saren. No. I mean, I've been watching a lot of Star Wars videos on YouTube. That's why I've been watching a lot of Generation Tech, is the channel I'm watching with Asian guy. But like, they have like a running gag with against dolphins on it. They often,
you feel away?
No, it's like, oh, it's cool. It's just serendipitous. Like, oh, but I'm a dolphin. They talk shit about dolphins.
They talk shit about them, though. You don't feel away? Because sometimes
they feel threatened by dolphins.
Oh, that they're going to take over. See, that's what it is. That's what it is. Insecurities, man.
But yeah, like, but I feel like I need to spread out and watch other channels and other videos just so like my views aren't completely biased. Because I like them so much, like my views are going to be skewed towards whatever their point of view is.
Do you remember Facts? Not Facts of Life.
Facts and Fears.
Not Facts and Fears.
Fear Factor.
Not Fear Factor.
Fear Factory.
Fear Factor.
The death metal band.
No, but they did a remake of the song Cars with Gary Numan on it.
But the drummer from that band is in my brother's band.
No shit.
No shit. They've never actually met.
That's fucking awesome.
It is cool.
I had a point.
You're pointing at me right now.
Yeah, no. Yes. Knock, knock.
Do you guys ever point like Bill Clinton? Who's there?
No.
Broken Pencil.
Broken Pencil who?
Nah, there's no point to this joke. That, like, there was
I'm mad for laughing.
I didn't even crack a smile.
No, look, the only reason why
I didn't say who.
Look, in all seriousness, the only reason why I brought that up today is because the knock knock joke originator won an award today.
Please tell me more.
The Nobel Prize. Yao Ming.
Bobby. We're going to have a talk.
One of these days, I'm just not going to show up anymore. I'm starting to joke about it more.
Okay, I'm sorry. Continue. Because I forgot my point.
You're two doors down, dude. You kind of...
Yeah. So? I have a lock on my door.
I might hit you with a knock-knock joke for real.
Oh, I want to shout out Calicles.
Oh, yeah.
He had my back.
Nice.
Someone was talking shit about me on YouTube, and he was like, no way, bro. Uncle Dolph is my homeboy. I'm like, hey.
Hey, how about
you? You're my homeboy.
How about you?
Oh, boy. I'll have to go read these comments now.
You think
someone's saying they want to get rid of me, saying I'm, what is he saying?
You think Calico might get an invite to Brofest?
I don't know. Where's Calico live? Can Calico bring a project and be okay with...
Or just sit there.
Manly silences that aren't awkward.
During the silences, do you guys ever just make eye contact just during the silence?
Just a little wink.
And, give it maybe a nod, an acknowledgement of each other's work.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, we definitely be like, check this out.
With the stiff frown.
Yeah.
Oh, is that I bring
my magnifying glass over to see what the fuck Joe's doing. Oh,
I got both of your Christmas presents today, by the way.
Did you?
I did.
I got us a present, all three of us.
Right. Well,
that's a resin 3D printer. So the three of us can have
nice. You
want to
put it over there?
No,
we have to have it.
See, see, Bobby, are you going to use it, Bobby?
No, we're keeping it Brofest.
Actually, why don't we?
Kelly's going to be the one who's doing all the
no
work.
No doubt, no
why
doubt.
Why don't we just get a DTOF and put it in a DTOF?
In the DTOF.
Yeah. That'd be a good place to keep
air
it.
Air fryer, a 3D printer, a resin printer.
And
a constructor.
And a constructor.
And it's on the bottom, so everything drips on it. Then I'm gonna try to sell it.
It's like a time capsule for museum.
That's perfect.
Quotable. Wrap the whole deet off.
That's right.
In a box and bury that bitch.
That's perfect. Perfect.
Oh my goodness.
Let's see what. Yeah, I have a question about Rebels.
Okay.
So
I'm not sure if I can answer. But
Yoda was talking to Kanan and Ezra.
As a
Kanan, at least.
Okay. Yes. Guiding him. Yeah, he talks to Ezra too eventually.
You see Yoda as like the Qui-Gon type Force ghost, mm-hmm. like with the light bubbles. But he was not dead yet.
Mm-mm. Almost like a projection.
Yeah, right? So he was in Dagobah and like fucking, right? He's in Dagobah at that point.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And just projecting, I guess he's probably bored. He's probably just fucking looking for somebody to talk to. Like, old motherfuckers at my job calls you up, talking prescriptions.
Because I often think, like, when he was on. Tyler wrote us a question this week and was like, Nerd Rage Radio, my favorite Star Wars podcast. But, Yoda.
You're an infection. That's what you are. You turned Shattered Cast into a Star Wars podcast, left, came here, turned this into a Star Wars podcast.
I'm not really mad about it.
The Dagobah, like Yoda.
You put some sauce on that. Damn. Dagobah.
The Dagobah.
You sing with a proper local accent.
He.
Local de hoot, hoomst.
The indigenous people of fucking Dagobah.
All right, so here's my question. Because do you think, obviously there's an act that he's putting on.
Yeah, yeah.
But
I think not completely.
Okay, so that's my question. Do you think it's 100% act, or is there a little bit of madness? I think there's a little bit of madness.
I think it's just madness. I think he's a goofy fuck.
I don't know if I'm buying
a goofy fuck vibe. When he talked to Qui-Gon, right, and they locked him, they kept him in the temple. Uh-huh. And then he asked Anakin to help him to get out, to sneak out, to go to Dagobah. He was a little goofy then. I was like, oh, I see the Dagobah. The playful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and there's a little bit of the playfulness, like in.
He's like a lot less serious.
Episode 2, you know, where he's like, how embarrassing. Obi-Wan's lost the stars.
Yeah.
You know, like, talking to the kids, yeah, there's a little bit of that there too. But the full on, like, how you get so big eating food of this kind? You know, like, he's lost it. And that.
I mean, he's been there for how long? 20 years by himself?
Cannot get your ship out.
I like it.
How did he get, I mean, I guess they just dropped him there.
That little pod.
Yeah, he has a tiny little pod sand pod.
That he took off from, because he's got good relations with the Wookiees, you forgot.
That's right.
That's a bit, it was a bit much, that bit. Like, okay, you got good relations with the Wookiees, do you? Like, just been kicking it? You know what I mean? I happen to know when you were 50 years old, you couldn't do shit. You know? So, okay, whatever.
But no, so like that was like a projection of sorts.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. Like a projection of consciousness, yeah. You know? Like, it's not quite as, you know, you can make the argument now in hindsight that it's not quite as powerful as what Luke did. You know, because he projected kind of like his vibe. Aura in a way. Yeah, but yeah. Luke projected like him, his physical self.
It's like astral projection.
Yeah.
But like things with the Force. Oh my God, it's going to be another fucking goddamn Star Wars podcast.
It's fine. This is the week for it.
This is the week for it.
But like the thing is, like just like in real life, when someone breaks a record, it gets broken a bunch of times directly after. Because once you can do something, it just fucking gets better and better.
Right.
Like, weightlifting, running, whatever it is. Right. So like. Because they didn't even know how to be a Force ghost first, right? Qui-Gon is the first one, and then they just got real fucking good at it.
Hang on, you said Qui-Gon was the first one.
Because Yoda says to Obi-Wan that Qui-Gon has taught me how to
immortal.
Communicate with...
Right.
Immortality, okay. I think. He said he unlocked the secrets of immortality.
Yeah. It is also kind of like that thing, like that evolutionary quirk where, you know, fucking chimps in the rainforest and... Brazil and chimps in the rainforest and the Congo, some fucking where, both start using coconuts to scoop water at the same time, where previously they hadn't been doing it. You know what I mean?
Like, you know, Jawas on different planets that are the exact same Jawas, except they're different.
So Jawas are native Tatooiners, apparently.
I actually watched a video about the history of the Sandcrawler and the Jawas.
Yeah, the Sandcrawlers aren't theirs, right? It's like
it was like mining equipment. Yeah.
And like Jawas and Tusken Raiders are the same
species.
Yeah. Like they diverged.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like, it was like a lush planet and it got fucking nuked in glass and turned to sand. And then, they devolved and then fucking went to
Like humans and dolphins, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Just like that.
Just like that.
Just like that.
That's cool.
But yeah, so the force projection thing. I don't know. I think the force is it's magic, right? Of Star Wars universe.
Right.
You can do
right.
fucking anything
yeah,
with it.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Fucking whatever Palpatine did in Clone Wars, he was fucking literally like magic. He had like a cauldron that he shot lightning into.
Yeah,
and
whatever he might be
Yoda's
doing.
Vision.
Whatever he might be doing on Thursday. You know, for, like, yeah. However that happened, like there's magic, you know, obviously.
But like there's no limit to what the force can do, apparently. Because it's the thing that binds the whole universe together.
When you want to go see Nine, let me know, because I'll go with you to see it.
I don't, again. whenever there's tickets or whatever. But see, I'm going to go in the afternoon when there's somebody else.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. I'll go. I mean, if it's a Tuesday or Thursday, I can go. Or Saturday, Sunday, but you're working usually.
Yeah, yeah. I might maybe Sunday after work. I don't know. I'll figure it out.
Yeah.
I'm in no rush. The only thing I'm rushing is I don't want fucking spoilers to start hitting. I'm going to start fucking punching babies.
Yeah, that's going to happen.
I know too many people. That know too much to be a
I mean, I've seen screenshots.
He's too dangerous.
I'll unfriend it. Anybody that gives me spoilers nowadays. I've unfriended a bunch of people.
At this point, I've seen literal screenshots of the movie.
That's what I'm saying. That's what, like, last night on Into the Realm, Tyler was talking about that. And, you know, he's an impatient fuck like you, and Dust is impatient fuck. Like,
Yeah, Tyler and I speak regularly about that kind of stuff.
Anyways.
Yeah, no, because if I get spoiled, I just won't watch it. There's no point for me at that point.
Step off of the shit. Step away from
I've been on the internet less today.
Yeah,
than
step
I,
away
I,
from
no,
it.
No, I'm just doing my usual. I mean, I haven't...
Because it's going to be out there. It's going to be out there.
If it is, then it is. I'm not going to change my fucking life just because somebody else is an asshole.
Good point.
I guess for whatever you think... Whatever it takes for you to win.
I mean, I wouldn't either way. I don't have to watch it.
You know, yeah,
I don't have to watch things to.
But
it won't bother me.
You're gonna watch it at some point.
Eventually,
right? So I mean, like, you know, but
it just won't be urgent.
I would say, like, look, man, I'm gonna win. I'm gonna win this battle.
I'll win regardless.
Well, not if you don't get to go and enjoy with your friend on his birthday.
I can't.
Birthday area.
Birthday month. We're in your birthday month now. That's right. It was a birthday and a birthday week. Now it's a birthday month. You know how people get
these bitches on Instagram talking about it's my birthday quarter.
Birthday quarter? Are you serious?
No, I'm kidding.
And then just rattle off some shit I watched that has no consequences because you don't care. More bad kung fu movies. Opium and the Kung Fu Master.
That sounds hard.
Doesn't it though? But it's funny watching these older Hong Kong kung fu movies and like seeing, how do I say it? Just seeing things I didn't see as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Like the opium wars, or the opium epidemic was a big thing in Hong Kong.
It's a big thing today.
Like, I mean, it changed. I mean, that's why Hong Kong got sold to Britain, one of the reasons. Like, it was...
That makes sense.
It was a big fucking deal. Opium
it's a big deal in America today.
Is it?
Opium? Like, opioids?
Not the same.
Joe, have you seen the signs? It's an epidemic.
Heron. They're telling you not even to take painkillers. You know,
because there used to be opium dens where people would just go and like lay down and
look,
smoke opium.
I don't know if it's like
that. Is why there was such a twisted opinion of Asian people in the West Coast,
correct,
during the 1800s, because opium dens.
It was just lazy Asian people laying around smoking opium
and them little hats. Nobody wants to see them little hats
and their little mustaches,
and then the whole gremlins thing.
You got a little hat and they got a rat tail goes all the way down.
And no, and shave front half.
You got no brim.
Watching you do that was wild.
old hairstyles are weird, man. Japan too. The Japan fucking samurai shits.
Oh yeah.
Also like shaved front half of the head.
Yeah, that was weird.
Yeah, the Americans just wore powdered wigs because they all had fucking lice.
Yeah, because everyone. I think it's every culture has their own way of solving balding issues. I think like older men was like, I'm balding, so everyone shaved the front half of their fucking head. I think that's how that shit started.
I mean, that's how I started out, but I just decided to shave all of it.
And I watched 36th Chamber 1, mm-hmm. 2, and 4, which is also kung fu movies.
Is there any particular reason why the Trace gets nothing there? And you only
it's not on Netflix for some reason.
Have you ever entered the 36 Chambers?
I have not. I would like to. The 36 Chamber
is... What's your favorite song on that album?
Cream.
Okay.
But the 36 Chamber is the ones that are for non-monks.
Yeah.
There's 35 chambers.
Oh, dude.
And the 36 chambers is one where you can join.
There was 9 members of Wu-Tang.
That was probably on purpose.
I bet you.
Because
They're weird. I mean, RZA is weird about that type of shit. You know, like,
there's an a cappella version of this song on
Yeah, I'm probably good on that.
But there's also a lot of like Hong Kong versus China type deal in those movies too that I didn't realize as a kid.
Yeah, you know, like
the Chinese were like the bad guys. The man.
So I deserve a check.
Uh-huh.
But I was listening to an episode of The Fifth Column, and they were saying how this guy on there is like what he like. Hong Kong has just no. I'm sorry, China has just started investing a ton of money into their quote unquote Hollywood, whatever that shit is. Like in the last year, they've started like dumping money into their shit.
Part yeah, they of have some big, they have some big like sci-fi movies and stuff.
Yeah,
but on Netflix and shit.
Within the last year, though,
yeah.
Like whatever they were doing, they've like quadrupled it. Like it's substantial.
Yeah, if you look like the top 20 movies of the year, there's a couple that you've never heard of.
Correct,
because of their Asian releases.
But they say that it has mostly it's jealousy with Japan. That Japan has anime, which mm-hmm. has like, you know, global cultural influence.
Yeah.
And China wants something like that.
Except like
so yeah, yeah. So they've dumped all this money mm-hmm. into their Hollywood.
Yeah.
And as a result, you can watch these movies and like there's this one movie they were talking about in particular. It's like a disaster movie, like a world-ending movie,
yeah,
right?
That's the same one I'm probably thinking of.
Roving Earth?
So here's the beauty of it, right? To watch, like you're saying, to watch and pick up the cultural influences and shit. That's kind of the beauty of it. Like, I fuck with that heavy. Just like when you and I have watched some of this anime shit,
mm-hmm.
and I'm like, man, look at the emphasis on fucking big explosions
and big disasters.
Fallout, and yeah. you know what I mean? All that kind of stuff.
And surviving. Yeah,
that's fucking... See, that shit's interesting to me. So, this is the type of shit it gives me. I love this type of shit. So... They were saying how like you have like a big disaster movie in American Hollywood, right? And you get the team of miners. You know what I mean? You get the team of miners. You get the one scientist to make a
yeah.
bomb. Yeah. The miners take the bomb and they get the fucking job done, right? Because yep. it's fucking America. Yep. That's how we roll. So, but they were saying in this movie, this big Chinese blockbuster disaster movie, guess who handled the problem?
Mm.
Take a guess.
I don't remember.
No, you haven't seen it. I haven't seen it. Take a guess. Who would handle it as a disaster? Right? That it's not miners that handle the problem. Guess who handles the
government
problem?
Government people?
The government
exactly.
people.
Exactly. Yep. It was the military.
It's the guy at the top. The guy at the top, and he's got the one with the grand idea, and he sends it on down the line. But it's just fascinating that it's that cultural influence just pouring through in their media. You know what I mean? Like, there's something to that shit.
It's weird.
For sure.
Like, anime and stuff is really focused on the individual. Like, individual standout breakthroughs that bucks the trend.
Mm.
But like the culture is not really like that. The culture is like go with the flow.
Right, right, right. But that's probably suppress shit.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like that
like,
lack.
Like all of anime is like that.
It's that hyper emphasized individuality in a culture where you feel like you have no individuality.
Mm.
I would imagine, you know, like just like, I mean, and you could pick our shit apart in the same way, you know, yeah. but I would imagine that's, you know, I think that in ours, you know, one of the big problems that we face is the, you can be anything.
Yeah.
You can be anything. You can be anything. And then you get to 35 and you're like, I'm not going to be anything. I'm going to work here at Blockbuster. I mean.
It's a good career. Paid the bills for a lot of years. And I got to watch Star Wars all day, every day.
Sometimes I set that shit up way in advance. Yeah. And y'all don't give me my fucking love, I feel like. But it's fine.
Don't tell Laura that you've been setting things up.
All right, continue.
I watched No Game, No Life Zero, which is a prequel to the anime and light novels, which is super serious and sad for like the anime, the mainstream anime and books are like really lighthearted and fun. But like the prequel to it... It's super fucking sad. It's a good watch, and you don't need to know the original source if you just want to watch an anime movie. It's on Netflix.
Mm.
It's dubbed, I think.
Oh, okay. I'll keep that in mind.
For your people.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
And lastly, so like my grandfather, the one with the side grandma,
mm-hmm.
last week he was in hospice.
Correct.
He's not dead. So my dad...
Make some noise? Or...
But like interesting thing is like he was like on his deathbed, like mm-hmm. like was gray.
Well, hospice is that exactly?
Yeah,
that,
yeah. Like he was like gray and not moving, and like my dad took like a picture with him. Like was supposed to be like the last picture. He looked like a corpse.
Shang Tsung.
Yeah, yeah. Shang Tsung before he sucked souls. But like my dad said, he asked him to come closer to want to speak to him, and my dad's telling me the story, and he went closer, and my grandfather said, "Tell him to go away." My dad's, what are you talking about? And his grandfather pointed over there. Is that dark guy over there? Tell him to go away.
Oh.
And my dad's like, "There's nobody over there." He's like, and then my grandfather, and he said,
"Shadow monsters."
Yeah, and then my grandfather said, it started talking to the corner of his head. "I don't want to go with you. Go away." Right. And then the next day,
shadow monster trying to get in the sidecar.
The next day, he discharged from the hospice, perfect health. So, like, he told death to go away, basically, as far as we know, because he was in hospice.
You should
ready
make an anime on that.
But, like, he's, like, up and about now. And, like,
that's crazy. That's crazy.
That I'm is fucking crazy.
I'm very I feel like we need to get Kelly's point of view on that.
Yeah, yeah. You got the medium wife over there.
That's right.
Dude, but if that's all it takes, man, fucking some strong enough willpower to be like, "Fuck you, I'm not going with you."
Yeah.
That's crazy. Because I ain't never had.
I got to remember that. Chances are I see the shadow monsters, I'll be like, "Oh, I guess that's it's what it is.
It's what it is. It's what it is. You tell him. It's what it is." That's what my grandfather said. I'm not going with him. You tell him.
Just run him off like somebody else's dog in your yard.
Like, "Get on out of here. Get on out of here." Like, "Get on out of here."
Because my dad was like so perplexed. My dad was like, "I can't believe that like happened."
Yeah.
No, what if the shadow monster just shrugged and like one of the orderlies just drops?
Well, he didn't say it was a monster. He said it was like a dark dude, basically a person.
I'm going to be honest with you. I thought I thought it was going to a racist place over there. And like your grandpa was like super
Yeah,
racist.
I thought it was going to like a racist place. But no, it's just shadow monsters.
Yeah, a shadow dude.
That's that shit from Ghosts, man. A lot of people say like the shit from Ghosts is based on other people's shit. Like a lot of people say they see that shit.
I mean, it's not. I mean, assuming it's there's death, right? It's not just ghosts don't come take you. Death comes take you, right?
But they say it's like a multiples. Like you know, like a lot of people say.
Oh, your family.
No. Yeah, yeah. People say that too. As a matter of fact, my grandmother, like for the year before she passed, she said she would always see her husband that died like back in the 60s or some
so,
shit.
So you gotta believe her. And
he would just be sitting at the end of her bed
waiting.
Yeah.
Like, she didn't tell him to go away. She went with him,
which is wild. But a lot of people, when they say they see the shadow monsters, they say like this, like you know, like I imagine like the
darkness. That's too cool. I'd go with that guy. If that guy was like, "Come with me," I'm like, "Oh yeah, let's go."
Like a whole bunch of like little like shadow monsters, just like you know, creeping on out, like having like here he is,
like in Ghosts.
There was multiple. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like Patrick Swayze shit.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
But like, so like, if you're on your deathbed, keep an eye out for that shit. That they're here to trick you, to take you away. Tell them no. Just say no.
Yeah, say
like,
no.
Was it Ronald Reagan or Nancy Reagan? Which one of them?
Nancy.
One of them. Nancy. Nancy said just say no.
Nancy could have said no with her mouth a few times.
Yeah, I mean.
She was outside. She was outside.
But yeah, like I can't believe it. He's fucking dead.
What did the Joker say? If you're good at something.
Never do it for free.
That's right.
It's wild to have a first lady that's like the 45th lady at the same time.
Right, exactly.
Wow. She's still alive, right?
Is she?
Nancy Reagan?
I wonder if she still got it.
I wonder, like, after he died, did she go to town?
Get out. Get out there. You know what I mean? Your life's not over.
Chris is looking it up.
AdultFriendFinder.com.
I remember that shit.
She died in 2016.
Oh. Rest in peace. God bless the dead. Sorry, it was terrible.
The bitch's name wasn't even Nancy.
It was
Anne Frances Robbins.
Oh, Anne out here acting fancy with Nancy.
With the E on the end of her name with that sauce.
But that's it.
That's it for you?
Yep.
Okay. All right. So we had to take a little time out for a second.
As we were saying, how we don't cut things out of the show.
Although we just don't put them in at all.
Yeah,
right?
And intermissions don't count. That's why I've been... Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. We had to save it. Pinkerton.
Hold on, I'm Googling young
Nancy
Reagan. I'm gonna zoom in on her mouth.
Dude, I bet you she had it, man. Like, because the way people talk about it, like, you know, said it felt like a blender made of tongues.
There's a headshot action. Check it out, man.
Don't say headshot.
Headshot. Polka dots. Headshots.
She was out there.
Barbershops. Yeah, lollipops. Yeah.
She was out there.
Yeah. She was doing her thing in the streets. Got the pearl necklace.
That goes.
Yeah.
That goes.
That was my elephant trunk.
With the pearl necklace.
All right. How was your nerd week?
Star Wars.
Yes. Nice. Oh, yeah. We watched Mandalorian. Dude. Oh, sorry. Oh, cut you off. Before you even get to start, let me cut you off before you even start.
Did you get into that Mandalorian thing?
Dude, did you guys like it?
Yeah.
Hmm?
You guys had a good time?
Like what?
You guys talk about it afterwards? Or
we didn't watch it together.
Oh.
No, I was like, but I was like, oh.
I have it in the notes. It's like a point of talking point.
We're always going to talk about Mandalorian. But like again, I'm just like excited that my significant other's into it. Because it was Friday. Cool. And I was like, you know what night today is? She's like, what? I said Mandalorian. She's like, oh shit, Mandalorian.
Nice. That's awesome. That's awesome.
But we'll talk about the show itself.
Pinkerton is...
Oh my God. How long has that been gone?
It's forward.
Well, he's got a haircut, though.
He got it cut.
It's fresh cut.
He got it cut.
This is cut on Sunday. I don't like it as this short. On
we took bets as to whether it was going to be forward or back.
And I said hats.
We all lost.
You got no hat.
We all lost.
Dude, I had you a drink laid out, and about halfway here, I remembered it's in the refrigerator still.
Oh, let me share one of my two mics.
Oh, hang on. Phil's bringing gifts.
Is it one shot?
Oh, nice. Punisher 2099.
Oh, wow. Punisher 2099.
A one shot? It's never a one shot with Punisher. I'll have you know.
Never.
So, favorite issue of Turtles from IDW.
Oh, that's awesome.
Nice.
That's Eastman?
Yeah, this is he did one of the covers.
That's awesome.
And then this is the brand new...
Look at that.
This is
good?
It's interesting.
Awesome. Check
it out. Thank you, Phil. You don't have to do this shit, but thank you.
Yeah, so watched a ton of Star Wars, and something interesting happened. So I was doing some work upstairs on laptop, and just honestly, for background noise, I put on the original trilogy.
Okay.
Wife comes out, sits down, finishes New Hope. She's like, we're going to watch the next one. I'm like, sure, why not? Put it on. She sat there and watched it. Was actively asking me questions, a lot of which I didn't know. Like, I don't know. Let me look it up or let me Google it. She was super interested in the timeline. When is this happening? How long has it been? How long was he in the carbonite? How does that?
Yeah, those are questions we all ask still to this day.
So I put on Jedi and had to leave, come back. She's been sitting there watching it the whole time. Next thing I know, she's watched all of those, episode 1 and episode 2, by herself.
Disney Plus is a beast.
So, I don't know. I'm
Journey to Nine, man.
Well, it's the exact same thing Joe's saying. It's super cool that, you know, my spouse is interested in the Star Wars universe, and she's asking questions and stuff. And I said, you know, you can Google this stuff because it's all on the internet. She's like, no, I'll get lost, and I'll never come out. I'm like, well, there's worse holes to fall into.
Yeah,
right, Joe? Right.
Are you hungry? Did you eat?
No, I haven't eaten since 7:30 this morning.
Chicken fajita shit up there. If you want to reheat it, you can just make it.
You serious?
Yeah. It's in the fridge, and then I have wraps and shit in the drawer. If you want to make something, you're welcome to.
Have her watch the timeline thing.
Miss out
shit afterwards.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
You don't care.
Yeah.
Like I put it on in our chat. The Clone Wars Year One, Year Two. Oh.
So I just subscribed to the guy you were talking about
because Asian guy.
I hadn't watched. Whatever the name you
said. The Clone Wars one, I started watching it.
And the full 45-minute timeline.
Actually, I had people hit me up saying, what's the link?
Oh,
really?
Yeah, so I forwarded it.
Nobody hit me up. No, don't hit me up. Hey,
they
I don't like... Don't hit me up. Hit Bobby up.
No, hit Joe up, please. Jesus Christ.
Sorry, I watched...
Hit Pinkerton. Fuck that.
Is this still the first Nerd Week?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Second.
I'm too busy.
Who went first?
Joe went first. So, I started watching Solo today. I just literally didn't finish it because I had to do something else. I still really like that movie.
Nothing wrong
with like
that.
The first scenes. I like it. The first scene's hard to get through for some reason. The whole
that you just made a clicking noise with your mouth.
That bit like
when, but I like when, it. I like it.
But I don't mind it. But once you get the Astro Mimban stuff, it
I like
really
Mimban.
Rolling.
So I've seen that movie 3 times. Of the 3. I super enjoyed it once, and I found myself watching it twice.
Yeah. Right. I mean, I went and saw it 3 times in the theater.
No big deal.
Theater.
No big deal.
Some people would brag about that.
You heard about
like,
him.
You know, Nancy Reagan.
You heard about Chris Pinkerton goes to see Solo in the theater.
Someone I went and saw it Solo in the theater, and I walked to a theater in Brooklyn one time, and the Google Maps walked me home, and... there were 4 buildings, and there was an intersection, and I had no business being anywhere in that quad.
Which is kind of rare, I feel like, in Brooklyn these days, because I feel like the last time I was in Brooklyn, I was like, where did all these bearded college kids come from?
The bearded college kids were at this
They left Greenwich and went to Brooklyn.
Like, Jesus Christ.
The theater I went to was I don't think it was you had to walk upstairs to get there, and people like were bringing bicycles and skateboards and shit in the it was very hipster, and you know, they had their beards.
I tripped and fell into a coffee shop.
It's not hard.
Sold records there.
Yeah.
Vinyl.
Yeah.
Just poured his head.
So I mean, there was
a good shit, man.
not the kind of acts that would come to Baltimore for a in store. Oh, right?
So yeah. I was saying, you remember in stores?
Yeah.
So here's a little bit of trivia, and I don't want to put you on the spot, but when I think of in stores in the Maryland area, I think of one music store specifically. Nothing's popping to mind.
No,
that's okay. Nothing popping to mind for
I know
Joe either.
Chain stuff.
So for me, it was Soundgarden.
Oh shit, that's right. Yeah.
Soundgarden.
I only went
the
there like once or twice.
That would have
not,
the in stores.
Yeah, that's true. They would.
They used to advertise those on 98 Rock all the time.
Yeah, and they had, like I was telling Pinkerton, because it's not, is it? Not, it's probably not there anymore.
No, Soundgarden, I still believe exists.
We should go down there. Yeah. We should go down there just to see it, because it's like a part of
yeah, it. Yeah, I haven't been there.
Where is it exactly?
It's at Fells Point in Baltimore, like off of Broadway. Well, you down to Broadway and you make a right, whatever that one is, by the water.
Yeah.
It is. But it's...
The Soundgarden, yep.
Yeah, but it's...
It's open right now, let's go.
It's...
Ridge Field Trip.
It's... I was saying how it's like it had that like comic book store vibe, yeah, where it's like dirty and yeah, dingy and like keep the casuals out. Like this is for music people in here. Yeah. I love that fucking place. Okay, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I was telling you about this little hipster place with Joe. There was this guy, man. He had this incredible, incredible beard. So I was like, man, you have a great beard. You know what he said back to me?
What?
He's like, I didn't like it at first, but it grew on me. So see, I hear these during the week.
How sick is Laura?
I hear these
that horn.
I hear these during the week, upstairs. Joe. And I wait. I was like, this is going to work somewhere. Kind of like the funny bone last week.
So is this why we have a second laptop now? Chris has his notes in a laptop.
Yeah. This is the Soundgarden, which
oh, shit,
honestly looks like the comic book skateboard shop I grew up going to. Right. The tattooed lady.
Yeah.
In lovely Huntsville. I watched.
It's big though, right? Like
it is big.
Yeah,
so to speak.
I went, I didn't, I'm sorry, I went, I watched the Movies That Made Us, Ghostbusters episode.
Yeah.
Super cool. Interesting.
Yeah.
I did not know any of that stuff. They actually had Dan Aykroyd, Ernie Hudson.
Egon.
No.
Egon. No. Hey.
Nancy Reagan was there.
Just as a shadow.
He wasn't there, Egon.
Oh, God.
But it was him saying that Ramis was a big skeptic against Aykroyd, because Aykroyd was a huge believer in his family history.
Yao Ming? He gone.
Yao Ming?
He gone.
But I didn't realize that Ramis was pretty much against it. He just was doing it for the comedy.
Yeah. Yeah, but like Dan Aykroyd's grandfather did seances and shit, so like the ghost thing was really embedded in them. And the whole
Aykroyd is a believer of many things.
Yeah, I don't know that much about Dan Aykroyd, but
tinfoil hat guy.
Yeah, he listening to interviews with him is wild
on another level, huh?
He was in a movie with Britney Spears, wasn't he?
I can't confirm or deny that.
Tell you what, she was.
What? Huh?
She was a problem in her day.
Britney Spears.
Them Southern girls will get you, Bobby.
Yeah, no, she was a problem in her day. Too young to be dressing like that on Rolling Stone covers. Where was her father?
I know exactly. I know exactly what you're talking about. You see, when I was in the movie industry, we sold magazines, and I remember it's like, God damn.
Yeah, God bless America. Jesus
Christ. Roll Tide on that.
All right.
Yeah, that's really it, man. Just probably picked up some figures and shit, but we don't talk about that here. So
we can. What'd you pick up?
Mezco.
Oh, for Christ's sake!
No,
we had one for fucking Christ show.
Hey, you didn't pick those up. It came in the mail with your paycheck.
Actually, kind of, sort of. So this week I got Mezco Cable, Mezco
Aquaman. You
have
to claim
Aquaman.
Your Batman figures on your W-2s?
Yeah, I do. Mezco Cable, Mezco Aquaman.
Permission
to come aboard.
Is it the one from the movie with the hair?
No, it's not.
Oh,
it's
man.
It's a comic
you were changing
version.
Your...
It's comic version, but he looks to me more like Ocean Master.
I thought you were changing out the water.
That's what
he
said when he looked at your shelves.
Yeah.
You want to change
to come aboard?
Permission to come. That's what he said.
Change out the water?
I got the PX Cyclops, which is the old school, like, full head cover. Cyclops. I got a whole bunch of other shit from them. So
no, well, we flex on them though. Just flex, okay, okay. Just fucking flex on.
Fine.
Them. No. Leave it be. Just be like, you know, a whole bunch of other shit. You know, whatever's out.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine.
They hear the beeps coming up to Chris's house, and it's a pallet jack. It just
beep, whatever's out. Bump. I couldn't even tell you. You know,
on the front lawn.
Some guy starts with, I don't know, his name starts with a C.
I'm going to be honest with you. There's so much shit piled up behind my desk, I don't even know what's there anymore. It's getting out
you can't
of
even
hand.
See the details
it's
anymore.
Getting, no, well, I mean, that's why I had to raise my desk up a little bit for Enter the Realm so you don't see
it. Nice.
Oh, man. I just want to bust out the back of my shirts. Flexing over here. Yeah, that's, I mean, honestly, I've just been super in Star Wars shit and cleaned up.
Tis the season.
Tis the season for sure. I cleaned up a little bit downstairs. Big party this weekend.
Oh, yeah, dude. I'm like, you're not making it.
I have to be out of town. It's the only time to see my dad for Christmas. So
yeah, fuck your bum ass dad, like, man.
I haven't physically seen him all year. Man.
I'm just kidding.
Real dad or side dad?
It's my real dad. I see my stepdad when I get over to mom, so whatever.
Side dad
is hard.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's just
yeah, it's a bummer.
Had to be that weekend.
Hopefully, Boogie will get people to get Laura. Somebody came down there. It was a shadow monster.
Yeah,
time to go away.
Laura, come here.
Just shout out to Raul. You know why?
Shout out to Raul.
Totally.
What are you doing? She's in the workroom.
She's hiding behind Christmas gifts.
What are you doing? What do you got going on for my birthday? You gotta have Phil because Phil's not gonna be able to make it to Christmas. So hopefully we can have a get together.
I have a half day that day, so Phil has a half day. I'm over in the afternoon.
He's gonna come on over, hang out, do some pizza.
So,
do you want to say anything to the people?
Hello. Merry Christmas.
You're gonna hate me for Bobby's birthday gift because I have something that's kind of big.
Two horns.
Oh, I have one giant dodgeball size horn.
It takes two people to operate.
Oh, we're taking next week off.
I know.
I forgot.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what.
For 2 weeks.
I'll tell you what. Well, but you know,
what about New Year's?
We're going to be doing a lot of podding.
There's going to be a lot of podding
coming up for Star Wars.
Speaking of podding, mm-hmm. I wanted to mention this. So right now in the Facebook group for Realm of Collectors, we're doing the year-end polls. Mm-hmm. So one of the year-end polls is a Realm Moment of the Year. Do you want to know what the top three are? Are you ready for this? Yeah. Number one is Bobby's speech at TFCon. Mm. Number two is Oscar returning to SCU. Mm. Uh-huh. And number three is Bobby leaving SCU. So it's about a mask fuck at our event and two fucks at art.
Did Robert D giving shots to everybody?
That's like number four.
Okay.
Except they put somebody put Robert G instead of Robert D. But I can only assume.
He doesn't make the cut.
I'm only assume they're talking about Robert D. Toff, attorney at lawyers.
Attorney at Amplian Stager.
Attorney at lawyers.
Yes. I do want to tell this story real quick. So yeah. I walked in today wearing a Mark Echo windbreaker jacket.
Dude, you flex. How are you going to flex on that?
I don't know, man. I don't know how hard. So this thing is.
You got any Vision Streetwear you're going to pop out on us? God,
that was on the back of the pallet.
I got some Stussy. I got some Stussy I'm going to pull out. It's just a green sweatshirt with the embroidery. That's it. I got it at Gadzooks in the mall. Shout out to William Fong for bringing that back around. He mentioned Gadzooks.
I haven't heard that name fucking forever.
Yo, I bought so much shit at Gadzooks. I'm like, this is the coolest store. But it was like 18, 19. Oh, I got Oakley's and me buy some of those. So I've got this windbreaker jacket. It's legitimately older than, it's probably from like 97, 98, whenever Echo started popping off. So I had a leather jacket. This is back when I was in the movie industry. Uh-huh. I was running the video store.
Sure.
And this kid that worked for me had that jacket. I'm like, yo, that's awesome. Where'd you get that? He's like, I got it at
JCPenney.
Gadzooks or whatever. Or the buckle or whatever.
It was right next to the South Pole shirt.
Yeah.
Buckle only in Alabama?
I don't know.
Remember South Pole?
South Pole. Oh, I got a good South Pole story, too. I got a good South Pole. So I had a leather jacket, and he's like, man, I'll trade you for your leather jacket. And I'd had this jacket for a while, like the pocket flap was ripped. I'm like, yeah, sure. So I traded him that, and like he was friends with who is now my brother-in-law, at the time just my friend. And I saw my brother-in-law now. I saw him a couple days later, and he was wearing that jacket. I'm like, what are you doing wearing that? Robert gave it to me. He's like, what did he give it to you for? Well, I mean, he traded me for some weed.
So I was making the rounds.
Hang on. There's the ogres have onions. Hang on. Ogres have onions. Have layers
like ogres.
But I bet that ogres have onions also.
Probably.
So I told my wife this story.
Smell like a man.
I told my wife this story because I literally had more in that jacket in years. I opened up the sleeve pocket and there was a receipt where I went and saw Days of Thunder.
Yo, I saw that shit in the theater as well.
I need to watch that.
I've never seen that all the way through.
No, you don't. But I'll shoot you some bail on that because I saw it in the theater.
Days of Thunder. It was some. I probably serendipity. I don't know. Some bullshit. It was
the first Fast and Furious.
Yeah. The first four Fast and Furious marathon. So I'm telling my wife this story, right? And I'm like, yeah, so I traded a leather jacket, and then your brother ended up with it, and some weed. And she's like, well, I can add another layer to that because that weed came from me. I'm like, what the fuck? She's like, you knew me before you knew me.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Fair enough.
Oh, God.
A million years ago.
Yeah. I was thinking about the South Park.
All, like, rushed to the frontal lobe.
South Park.
South Pole.
South Pole. My grandma had bought me a South Pole shirt. I didn't request it. She had bought it. And it was loud as fuck.
Let me guess. It said South Pole on it.
On the collar.
Yes.
On the collar. And it had like racing shit, like all this shit, like all over. And I was like, look, I wasn't ever with the loud shit, like clothing wise. Like I was like hoodies, jeans, low key. And picture day comes around.
Oh, shit.
My grandma paid for my school pictures. Similar. Not that exact one, but not far off.
Jesus.
Not far off. Not that. Not that, but not far off. It was more yellow and black. Like you. It wasn't me. And she was like, "You should. I paid for your pictures. I want to have a nice picture of you. You want to wear the new shirt I got you?" And I was like,
Toys R Us thing is badass.
I can wear it. So I wore it. Hoodie on, right on top. Never took the hoodie off. It was like middle of June.
Never took the hoodie off.
And like you can just see in this one school picture I have, it's just the South Pole on the collar underneath the hoodie.
Bobby, you didn't tell me that you modeled for South Pole.
Dude, that does kind of
look like him. Back when you were a little thin.
It does kind of look like me.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Let me tell you my funny South Pole story. So South Pole, at a certain point in time, she ended up being a JCPenney brand. And it was actually like a streetwear brand for a while, but then it was like, it was a JCPenney. So Kelly and I went on a cruise with her brother and his girlfriend at the time, who literally had never been, bless her heart, had never been out of the trailer park in her life. So she
had a girl, Becca.
So we go on this cruise. And we had like, the cruise got in at like 8 or whatever. And I think our flight wasn't until like 8 at night. So we had a whole day. So we go to some random mall, and I remember we were at JCPenney, and she's like, look, Lane, they've got South Pole. Like she had found the fucking grail or something.
It's a big deal in a single wide.
I guess.
Single wide.
This is the same girl that brought pictures, the only picture she had of her grandmother she brought with her on this cruise and set them up like in the bedroom. And then she bought liquor and put it in her suitcase. And I remember.
Look, I know the vibes on that one.
I know, but when we get like to the airport and you know, the bags are soaked, she's like, "My grandma's pictures." She was so upset about her grandma's pictures being covered in brown liquor. Should have just got vodka. Oh
man,
Bobby,
my buddy Lloyd threw this hot potato at a girl's face one time.
A hot potato.
That's a weird flex.
Was there any topping?
So the reason why I'm bringing it up, is because you said my grandma's pictures and in that voice. So we were in the lunch line, me and the crew I ran with, and my buddy Lloyd, who was a chill dude generally, but he just grabbed this hot potato and just opened up the tinfoil of it and just threw it, and
indiscriminately or purposefully,
indiscriminately. Just threw it.
Like look with that lightsaber.
So the moment, no, but not over the shoulder.
Okay.
To the side.
Why?
So like a split second later, you just hear the lightsaber. Ah, it hurts! So we looked over and there's this girl, she's got a hot potato like all over her face. She's like, it's hot!
Oh, it busted?
She took the tinfoil off.
It's like the most fucked up game you can play.
And she's like trying to swat the hot potato off and then The assistant principal came in and was like, "Who did it?" And the lunch lady was like, "I don't know, but I know it was one of them," and pointed to like me and my friends. She was right, but you know, it was also fucked up, low key. We'll move on, bring it back to a level of maturity.
No, it won't.
You know, one of the, my favorite compliments I've ever gotten about this show, somebody hit me up and said, nice show. It's the only podcast I listen to. I don't listen to at double speed.
That this is hard to listen to at double speed. It is. I listen to most of my stuff at like 1.2 or 1.3, but even this is hard to listen to at anything past just regular.
It's fast paced. It's high speed, low drag. You know what I mean?
It's a lot going on. It's almost like you could do two tracks, like left and right. Listen to the left side for Joe and Chris's conversation and right side.
Throw conversation.
Right.
Yeah, but it's
it's got to be the left side, though. Phil, Bobby wants to know if you want to hang out this week.
Phil, what are you doing, man?
The Brofest salt is real.
Trying to have Dude Fest?
Dude Fest.
That doesn't sound right. It sounds
Dude Fest. Oh, my gosh. Oh,
Brofest taking the world by storm, man. So, okay, let's move on to the next portion of our show. Which is our special guest, Nerd Week. Phil, how was your nerd quarter, nerd week, whatever? Actually,
last time I was here.
You've made a fair amount of shows this year.
If you could do it in the evenings or on the weekends, I try and make it whenever.
I like doing it in the evenings.
I skipped lunch today, man.
Because like, it's always like, because I can let loose. You have no like responsibilities for the day are done. But for me, anyway, that's how I feel.
For you.
Your responsibilities are always done, Joe. But like my responsibility is like, I'm checked out for the night.
Hey, I've only got one phone with me, buddy.
Oh, my God. Dude, is this Pinkerton's Biggest Flex? Is that the name of this show?
Non-stop.
I mean, it might as well
I had it as Egon Yao Ming, but I'm changing it to Pinkerton's Biggest.
No, I like Egon Yao Ming. I think that's good, too. Pinkerton's Biggest Flex. I mean, I
think I'm changing it to Pinkerton's
Biggest
Flex.
It's like when you fuck up, you take the Viagra, and you get a four-hour erection.
I mean, I guess I should probably mention that I finished building and shipped out 15 office dioramas this week.
Actually, and they look beautiful, by the way. Seeing a picture of it, it looks like you're working on a fucking assembly line.
Yeah, let me tell you, I felt like I was. Actually, I have the three international ones I still have to do because I have to wait on
the international ones.
The floor pieces come in. I ran it.
This guy's out of control. Somebody get in his pockets.
I'm sending one to Hong Kong. I'm sending one to Thailand, and I'm sending one to Japan.
Is it for Hong Kong? Is it for the riot fucking figures?
Yeah, that's exactly what it's for. Yeah, I got a contract with those people.
They're like, look, we just want the glass walls just as big as you can make them.
What would be fucked up is if it was a mainland Chinese company making the protest figures.
Is that what Brofest is all about? You guys are making ship over to Asia?
No.
Dude, don't be putting limits on what Brofest can be. Brofest.
I hope there's not one of those because I'd like to be in on that one day.
Brofest is.
I'm not including Brofest either.
No, listen.
Brofest is from here to the moon.
You just have to bring a project.
It just doesn't include you or I, Phil. From here,
no,
from here
that's
to the moon.
Not, no.
From here, you had to be facing this way to the moon.
It goes from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m.
That's right. Every other odd
Wednesday,
Thursday.
Only days that end with Y, where Bobby can't make it. That's the prerequisites.
Listen, just be glad your wife only has one birthday a year. Come up with another excuse.
You know how you know how the mob burns a saint in their hand? When Brofest meets, they burn a picture of me in their
hand. It's the emblem on the door.
Phil, how was your nerd quarter, nerd week, nerd month, whatever it was?
It's good. I saw Knives Out. I don't remember if I talked
about it. How was that?
That was excellent.
I heard I want to see that shit bad because it's supposed to be some sort of like low-key commentary on what he's been dealing with Last Jedi and all that shit.
That's open to interpretation. I didn't really totally get that vibe. I guess I could see that, but it was more just a like tour de force of acting performances.
And nice.
It's a,
that dude knows how to make a fucking movie, man. Yeah. I don't give a fuck what anybody says.
Yeah.
All the cast did amazing, like even down to like the bit roles. So like it was cool to see Chris Evans do something that wasn't Captain America, and he basically did an exaggerated version of what he used to do when he first started acting.
I saw him do a movie where he like adopted like his sister's kid.
That's one of his.
In my opinion,
that's one of his two best roles.
It was a good fucking movie.
Yeah. Snowpiercer's really.
That's
good.
The other.
I love Snowpiercer.
That and Snowpiercer are his two best roles. But
Snowpiercer sounds like trash.
That's a fucking good movie, dude. It is fucking phenomenal,
Bobby. That's when you fucking snow to keep warm.
It's a sequel to Willy Wonka. The Chocolate Factory.
Dude, that YouTube video, I watched those. Those are wacky, but it pretty much rings true.
Yeah, it's headcanon for me.
Yeah.
What do you get when you gobble down sweets?
Anybody?
Nobody?
I don't like the look of it.
I never forget the rowing
scene
with all the creatures on the wall.
There's no earthly way. No. It's my all-time favorite movie is
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
The Gene Wilder version. Yeah. That's the cover of that song that I really like.
Oh, yeah.
I've heard that before.
What is it? Who did the song, I Don't Like the Look of It? You know, it's like a.
There's been a couple techno kind of.
No, it's a rap. No? It's a southern. I would think you would know this.
It's a somebody a southern rapper. Sample
Tennessee, wherever the fuck you're from.
Yellow Wolf,
motherfucker.
I don't like the look of it. Let's see. I'm gonna pull this up real quick. Oh, Backwoods.
I'm not familiar with Backwoods.
But have you heard the Mariah Manson track?
I sped up. Anyway, right? It doesn't matter. Continue.
Have you heard the Mariah Manson track between
Mariah? Yeah. I'm not. Look, it's fine.
It was funny. Anyway, I just saw Dark Waters, which was the Mark Ruffalo.
That's movie. The cartoon with the pirates.
They never fucking finished.
I hated that cartoon.
I like that. I just hate it didn't finish.
I was a kid, I loved it.
It wasn't as good as like the other stuff that I did like.
The toys
like
look cool.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I never had any of them.
It reminds me of that one Stephen King movie with like three short stories at the end. It was like a lake monster that's like that. It comes to fucking eat you.
Yeah.
Creepshow, I think.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was Creepshow. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. Dark Waters was the story about DuPont and the Teflon.
Teflon Don.
What city or state was that in?
Takes place in West Virginia, but it insinuates that it's all over the world, which basically everybody has Teflon in their body by now.
Oh, okay.
All across the planet. There's John Gotti, right? There's less than 1% of people that don't have Teflon in their system.
Speaking of John Gotti and snitches getting free, such as Sammy the Bull, Tekashi 6ix9ine looks like he's coming home free of
really?
All. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow. So
is he going to have protection the entire time?
He's going to have to.
Yeah, there's no way.
I was gonna say, like, what's the over under on him being in a body bag soon?
Yeah, I don't know.
Just disappearing, never be heard from again.
You know, but Izzy, here's the question: is like, I'm hesitant to even say this because I'm not gonna say it. We'll talk about it off air. But there is a question as to if he walks away from this scot free with no consequences, what does that say about everything that's going on in the world today? You know, but I have.
It's a crazy litmus test for
this social political issues. This shit is going to go down in history. And I've been saying that since day one. It's why we've been kind of talking about it here. Like, this is different. It's for a musician to go down on a RICO charge, it's special. For him to snitch out on every fucking body in the world, including Joe's side grandma, is also special.
That's going to be a whole 5 minutes in the movie when they make it.
The movie's coming. The movie's already it's already booked. Like, there's a documentary coming on Showtime, and then they're like, it's coming. You know? Like, but here's my question is, does the world still operate the same way?
That world?
Mm-hmm. And time will tell.
Yeah, well,
hey. Time will tell. And I'm not saying he deserves it because there is a larger question to this is that, you know, these guys were fucking his wife. They were robbing him from money and everything else. Like, does he owe them loyalty?
I don't think he ever
his
owed
wife,
him.
His girl.
I don't think he ever owed him loyalty because he got put in that world as a financial tool.
Yeah.
And just, you know, took the street cred with it.
So, I don't know. It's going to be interesting to see how these next couple months play out.
Hey,
I sent that picture to Jizz real quick, the same one I sent to you guys in the chat, and Jizz was like, well, this might make the second half of my week more interesting.
We talked about it last week, this Nick Cannon Eminem beef. I don't know if
you
saw.
A lot of people hit us up about that.
So there was a lot. Joyner Lucas hopped on and basically said,
hang on.
He said to Nick Cannon, basically, I'm going to drag anybody that's ever had anything to do with. And then Obi Trice has jumped in on it.
Well, Obi Trice is facing a fucking murder charge.
Wow. Unrelated to this. unless you're saying his bars killed Nick Cannon.
He killed his girlfriend's son or some shit. Or shot at. Oh. Maybe he just shot at. It was assault. I don't know what it was.
Well, Eminem has not responded other than a clever tweet or two, but rumor has it he has an album coming out Friday.
M?
A whole album?
And he dropped the album this year or last year?
It was last year.
With Venom, gonna get him.
Venom.
It was right around the same time.
So I'm thinking my man has been full of Venom about this Mariah thing for 15 years.
Say full of Venom.
And it's get him, and it's going to be 10 tracks of him ripping Nick Cannon a new one. He might have God and everybody on these tracks. He might have Suge Knight saying, "Hey, Nick Cannon, or whatever your name is."
I can't see, like, it's not. I don't like that.
You don't like what?
That concept, that idea
of, like, what, putting an album out like that?
No, putting an album out like that. Like, all right, Michael. All right, so,
ladies and gentlemen, please be prepared for Bobby's rant of the week.
Yeah, here we go. Jaina, I love her to death. I think she's incredibly smart, incredibly bright. The basketball, not in her future. Sure. Not in her future. That's not what the Lord has set out for her.
Okay.
Who the fuck wants to see Jaina play Michael Jordan? Who gives a shit?
I see I see what you're doing.
Look, I am not the biggest Eminem fan. I've been very vocal about my criticisms about him on this platform. The man is incredibly talented at what he does.
He's a weirdo, though.
But who the fuck gives a shit if he, like, dude, you hear what he did to Nick Cannon? Like, yeah, I heard what he did to Nick Cannon, and I heard what he did to Ja Rule, and I heard what he did to Mariah Carey, and I heard what he did to Britney Spears, and a whole bunch of other motherfuckers that can't rap.
Yeah.
Tell me what Eminem can do against somebody that can actually rap. Because when Royce went at him, I didn't get a whole lot of that energy. Royce told D12 that Bizarre was digging his own grave with a fork and spoon,
mm-hmm.
and that in 1 year, D12 would be raking 50s leaves. Like, I don't care what M has to say about people that aren't anywhere near his skill level, but that's the people that I feel like he tends. Benzino. These are the people that he goes at.
Benzino.
Who don't have a snowball's chance of going against
him. Yeah, go against somebody with some fucking. Go against Hove. I bet you don't want to pick that bone. Do not bark up that tree. That tree will fall on you. That's the type of stuff that I'm talking about. If you want to go, if you want to prove to me that you have the minerals, don't do it with Nick Cannon.
No. Well,
not on the mic. Okay. Not on the mic.
No, I get you.
If you want to prove you have the minerals and you want to deal with Nick Cannon on the street, because Nick Cannon comes from a very real place, I'll buy that. But on the mic, I don't want to hear Nick Cannon battle you.
What about his group of battle rappers from Wildin' Out? Do you want to hear from them? Because that's who he's dragging on these tracks.
Oh, good. Perfect. Hey, look, and they, can everyone agree at the very least? I like Nick Cannon. I think that he's fine. I like his podcast. I think has been pretty good. I've caught a couple episodes.
You get a podcast, and you get a podcast.
Yeah.
Has a podcast.
I've only listened to the few where I've been interested in the guests. So, like, Dame Dash, he interviewed. I was interested in that, and I like it. But can we all just agree? Here I am defending Nick Cannon. That I don't want to see M beef with Nick Cannon in 12 tracks. I don't want to see him beef with Nick Cannon on one track. I don't want to see him beef with Mariah Carey. I don't want to see him beef with the Backstreet Boys. Fucking Eminem beefs with trash, motherfucker.
I don't know how much meat you can get on.
What about Moby?
Exactly. So can we all just agree that at the very least, and I say this with all due respect and love for Nick Cannon, he should take the fucking turban off. It looks silly.
He's wearing a turban?
That's why he's not on America's Got Talent.
It's silly. Yeah, that's it's not a good look for him.
Why is he wearing a turban?
It's something. He's making a stance.
Yeah, he's trying to make a stand.
I don't know if he's still doing that because he hosts some other show.
It just doesn't look good.
He has his own show now too, doesn't he? Something.
Sure. why not? Anyway. He had headphones too. So
I'm sorry, Phil. You were saying about your week. Who do you want to see M rap against? Metallica. What the fuck up, Phil?
I do love Metallica. But.
I know. I love Metallica, too, yeah. To a point.
Yeah. Favorite Metallica song, Phil.
Let's go around the table.
I can do album. I don't know if I can do song.
Well,
okay, I can't put an album on a fucking playlist, Phil.
Let's just say Harvester of Sorrow.
All right.
That's a 40K book.
Probably. I would not doubt it.
Is that the same as Man of Constant Sorrow?
No.
By the Soggy Bottom Boys.
Oh,
whoa.
I like that movie.
I'm serious.
Oh, brother, they're out there.
Yeah. Oh, brother. The soundtrack is pretty good.
Hey, you. What about you?
Justice for All. The song, not the album.
Okay. Because the album is probably objectively their best album.
Yes. Definitely.
Yeah.
It's the only album of theirs I actually own as a CD.
Pinkerton?
Sad but true.
And mine would be For Whom the Bell Tolls. Do you want to see James, whatever the fuck his name is, rap against Eminem?
James
Hetfield?
Yeah, because he puts that salsa.
It'd be easy for him to rap. That's how he ends every line.
I bet you Lars could play the snare drum to Eminem.
And then do
he'd probably do it at 16th notes.
Double bass.
But you wouldn't be able to download it anywhere. Continue.
Those motherfuckers, man.
That was great.
Like, yeah, I lost all respect for them in the early 2000s.
I mean, I get it, though. I get wanting to be paid for your work. You know, what's wrong with that?
I get their argument.
So
I can see both sides, but...
Nothing for me, right? Performed better than anything I've ever done. I made a third or less money on it, right? So I get it. They put their heart and soul to it. I think they deserve their money. I don't think that you should be able to just take it for free. I honestly do. I think they acted like douches about it.
Yeah, that's the problem. Okay,
but the principle I'm behind on, just how they went about it, was douchey.
Yeah, it was very bad.
Yeah.
It's very
did you get your?
That's
the problem.
Fuck their image. So that's a separate conversation, and that I'm 100% with you. It made them look fucking like they were counting their nickels and dimes.
Yes,
where like was the metal answer to it would be like, whatever, let the music live on.
Yeah, they're becoming fucking labels.
Okay. I'm with you there.
I mean, they were way too commercial about it.
Yeah. I'm with you there. Okay, cool.
Did you get Spite squared away for when it comes out?
Yes.
So it's going to be on YouTube, because I've been telling people.
Yes, it's all good.
It's all good. Game
so I wrote to. So I use. I'll put it out there. I use TuneCore. Right. Mm-hmm. Other people use this and that. Whatever. Some people have better splits or whatever. I don't give a fuck. TuneCore is pretty consistent. Okay. They're kind of like a standard. So okay. I use TuneCore. They wrote me back immediately and they were like, "Your shit's banned, et cetera, et cetera. It won't be getting. Please do not upload again. You will be banned from our website, the IP address, like all this shit." I was like, okay, well, I wrote him back and I was like, look, can you tell me what I did wrong? And if there's anything I can do to fix it, because if I can fix it, I'll fix it. Because I was thinking maybe it was the pistol on the promotional art because of the clue shit.
Yeah.
And they wrote me back in 72 hours. They said it'd take 48, but I'm not counting. 72 hours. And they said, yeah, we apologize. We fixed it. It'll be up and running. Don't worry about it.
No shit. All right, good.
But I mean, like, give me an explanation. Why the fuck did you do that?
Yeah, yeah. Right. Give some kind of explanation.
Yeah.
I, too, have watched most of the movies that made us. The only one I haven't seen is Dirty Dancing, because I don't care about it. But
what? You better make sure Laura's not around the corner.
I'm waiting to watch with Kelly, because she wanted to see that.
Dirty Dancing 2, Havana Nights.
No.
You didn't see that.
No, did you?
I don't know. Maybe there was a double feature. Dirty Dancing 2 and Serendipity.
That's like the Truce of Bakura of film.
Those two would be like, that's a rainy afternoon on fucking TBS. It's Joe watching those two movies back to back.
But for the Home Alone.
Or like one of four female listeners liked that series. You just keep shitting on it.
No, Anna lied to me.
Oh.
I have respect for her, but she came on that fucking podcast and lied to me about reading that book. Nobody's ever read that book.
Wait, which book?
The Truce of Bakura.
Oh, yeah, I've not.
No, nobody has. It's a fact. It's the only book ever written nobody ever read. Like, anybody who's ever read it, I'm like, what's your favorite part? It's like, I don't know.
It's like Wu Tang's album, the album that's made that's never heard.
Yeah. It's like, what's your favorite part of that book? I'm like, oh, this book doesn't go to my school. I'm like, wait, what?
That one took a minute to unpack, Bobby, but I got it. That's pretty clever.
Anyway,
is that George Glass?
Yeah, you know who
George Glass is. You ever met George Glass?
No.
You guys, nobody knows who George Glass is. Uh-huh. So that was Jan Brady's make believe boyfriend. You don't?
Oh, really?
I don't even know Jan Brady.
Ooh.
From the Brady Bunch?
Here's a story
lady. Yeah. No, I know the crew.
I haven't watched that shit.
Jan Brady, the middle one.
She beefed with him, I think.
Yeah. they actually released a couple tracks, and he just like shut them down, you know.
Oh, he's so brave.
Yeah, he is. He's a brave guy.
He's so brave.
Anyway, where was I going with that? Train wreck. It's your...
Phil's nervous.
Derailed. I never knew that Home Alone had to switch studios like in the middle of making.
Yeah, I haven't seen
it. I hadn't watched that one.
It's pretty crazy. And
the one thing I want to hear about is this Die Hard shit. Do you know what I'm talking about? So the Realm had... I've said this, I think, on last week's show, but the Realm had this dude on their show. Right?
Brian Volquash.
Oh, yeah.
And they interviewed him.
Yeah, yeah.
And they were like, you know, tell us something about the movies that made us. And they were like, look, I can't tell you anything about it, but when you get to the Die Hard thing, just remember I was shocked by, I can't tell you, but just, I'll say this. turtle wax or it was some random ass shit.
I have to go back and listen to it.
I don't remember.
Yeah, and then like in my head, I was like, man, I got to watch this now to remember this point. But now I've forgotten both the point and I haven't watched the show. I'm just a fucking mess.
It's been too long since I've heard the ED.
My entire
episode.
Life is a fucking disaster right now, Phil. I've gotten 3 hours of sleep in like I feel like the past 6 days. Like that's another thing I didn't mention on my nerd week. I'm not sleeping.
That's your new thing now?
I'm not. No. It's not my new thing. I don't want it. But I'm not sleeping.
Yeah, I'm
like,
are you laying in bed tossing and turning? Or are you up doing stuff?
I'm laying in bed tossing and turning. And if I'll go to sleep at like maybe 10, 11. I'll wake up 2, 3, 4.
It's probably there's just a wavelength here.
I'm not sleeping.
I'm right there with you. And I will also say that being a long in the tooth gentleman,
that
as Bobby
is true.
Likes
you're
it,
fucking
my,
just knocking on the grave.
My 42nd to 43rd year, my body has completely fallen apart.
Mm.
I'm groaning getting off the couch at this point. So,
but you're also tall as a motherfucker. So
I am.
Yeah, your knees have got to be hurt.
I'm predetermined just to be
a stool is your chair. I feel like
it technically works the best. Yeah. So, but yeah, I'm the same way. I'll sleep 4 or 5 hours, and we talked about sleep on here before. That's kind of I work in that pocket. So I can either lay in bed and toss and turn, or I can just get up and fucking get on it.
When I know I'm getting, when I have to get up for work at 4:15. And I'm up and ready to go, and my alarm has not gone off, there's a problem.
Mm, yeah.
Big one. And it's happening all the time.
Have you tried taking, like, melatonin or
I haven't. I've taken melatonin in the past, but it started fucking with my head a little bit, I feel like. And my mental state is very...
You just gotta fight.
It's a very
fragile
it's
balance.
Very fragile.
It's a teeter-totter effect.
Yeah, it's not good. It's not good. Just leave it
alone. Was there a guy? Was a shadow guy?
I'm like, don't look at it. Don't look at it. It doesn't work if you look at it. I don't know what... I'm off for the next 2 weeks.
Wow. No shit.
Which is nice. So I'm going to try to really...
All right.
Meditate, whatever it takes, get my shit to get center my chi.
I know what'll get you centered.
You like that?
I know what'll get you centered.
Yeah?
Brofest.
Oh, off so you can.
Maybe it's not being invited to Brofest. It's been fucking me, not being able to make me sleep.
Oh, yeah, listen, wasn't that you weren't invited? All
right. I showed up to Brofest. This is a long story.
Really?
I wasn't going to mention it, but I showed up this last time when they took the little. You saw the selfie they took?
Yeah, yeah.
I showed up to that. Chris Pinkerton lifted up his shirt just to his nipples, and on his stomach, it had a skull with a Ghostbusters line through it.
I thought you could say he took out his balls to go against you.
I just looked at him, and he said, you know what that means? Not fucking welcome. And he closed the door.
If only.
All right,
if only.
Bobby and I are going to build the Lego Batmobile.
He's going to build it, and I'm going to watch it. And I'm going to also drink and make jokes along the way.
Great show.
Yeah, Dude Fest.
Dude Fest. Dude, you're not even coming to Dude Fest, bro.
All right, that means I'm going to come over and play Injustice or Mortal Kombat at some point.
Yeah, I got to play that shit myself. Yeah. I'm still playing Jedi Fallen Order. I have beaten it. I'm trying to get all the secrets and shit. But
all the colors of the lights.
I got to practice now that I got an Xbox. So.
Yeah, it's not going good. But anyway, continue.
It's probably just Star Wars fucking you up. After you watch
it, might be.
After you watch
it
Star Wars,
be.
You might sleep really well.
It might be.
Like Thursday night.
You laugh. It might
no,
be.
No, I'm serious.
Yeah.
That's why I'm thinking. If it's just be. Recently, in the last week, it's probably like you just can't fucking get your shit together because you need to watch it.
You do have. We're still going to talk Mandalorian, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, Phil. Go ahead.
That's right.
No, because
this episode could also be called Phil. Go ahead.
I'm so disjointed. I don't know what I was going to say
now. The whole show's disjointed.
So if we go into news, I might pop in with another thing at some point. I don't know.
I'm so brave. I'm so brave to surrender like that.
Okay. I know why I forgot that in my nerd week, because I haven't fucking done my nerd week yet. Let me tell you about my nerd week.
All right, go ahead, Bobby. I will cut you off.
One hour and 23 minutes, Bobby starts his nerd week.
Finish The Watchmen.
Amazing. I got some.
Did you reset your DVR?
On my feed.
It's far from fucking amazing. But
how much longer was the episode?
Because that was a big deal. Terrible.
Huh?
It's not terrible.
Uh-huh.
It's poor.
So what was the best episode? Was it good in the end?
The one before
right
the
before
last
the
one.
End. Okay.
The one before the
how
last.
How long
one.
Are these episodes?
An hour.
Fuck. Well, the last one they said was going to be extra long.
And that's an hour and 7 minutes.
Really? That's it? Yeah. Oh, fuck.
Are you kidding me?
Did they tell the newspaper? Well, there was a fucking online article about it. It was ridiculous. I was like, I thought it was going to be like 2 hours.
So, the ingredients aren't bad. but the way they went about the soup is not good. You know what I mean? It could have been a hearty meal or a beefy stew.
Yes.
Instead, or it but could, instead could have of been a beefy stew, they made a saucy soup.
Or what, oh, no, they didn't make a laughing stock.
Gosh!
round and round we go, gentlemen.
Somebody give me some
love. He's getting us back for the fucking Aquaman shit a year later still.
Permission to come aboard.
Yeah, so, but I'll tell you. The guy who, this one dude, the dude who played Black Manta.
Oh,
he does. In it? Yeah, okay. And he does full frontal.
What character?
The
does
fucking
he play?
Hammer on this dude.
Oh, he's
he doesn't. He's not. You know. But here's the thing that pisses me off about that. Right. Look, and like it's
genetics.
Kudos. Right. Big up to you. You know, live your best life.
Can you get CRISPR to change the dick size?
Me?
Not you. I'm just asking a question. And
look,
there's going to be multiple genes involved.
Let me go on the record here, okay? I'm not a handsome man. I'm not a handsome man. My skin is varying degrees of poor to dry to trash.
Because you like it dry. Right? That's your problem.
Also true. My eyes are deep sunken, and I've gotten 3 hours of sleep in the past 6 days, so they're black orbits with my eyes.
He's starting to look like
his face has started to look like the mask.
Time is upon us, Skywalker.
Soon you will no longer need to wear the mask. The mask will wear you, Bobby.
Right. And I'm being objectively fair about myself. Okay, I have I'm a strong, physically strong person, but I do not have. I have a gut. I like to eat. I like to manja. I like to get in the shits. Okay. My dick is 1000% the most attractive thing about me. In a perfect world, I would use it as my profile picture. Okay.
Well, you can in some sites.
There's probably a place for you in the world.
I'm proud of it. I wish I could make my first impressions with it instead of what you see before you. That being said, this dude, he's doing his thing. Game recognized game. My hat's off to him.
was that some sort of clever, like, prophylactic joke?
Well, I think
hat's
No, he's uncircumcised
off.
As well.
A lot of anteater jokes around here.
As well.
Yeah, but we're both more V-neck than turtleneck. You know? So like, anyway, but here's what pissed me off about it. I read an interview with him.
Okay.
And in the interview, he was like, yeah, you know, I was just, you know.
Can you please internalize his voice as Michael Jackson, please?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
The thing is, me in a vulnerable place.
That's even better than I thought it could be.
But I want to give a moment and say thank you to the director and producer. It made me feel very comfortable. Like, dude, no. You don't get to feel very fucking comfortable when you get the hammer on you. Okay? Okay? You got some guy with a fucking 2-inch dick. That's the guy who you say he made me feel comfortable.
Yeah, like because you don't want to be on camera. Yeah,
this guy feels comfortable in Antarctica. You know, like he's,
you can see it from behind.
He's doing fine.
Yeah,
he's doing fine. You know, he also has an oddly shaped head, the proper one.
Which one is the proper one?
We are talking about this way too long.
But I say that to say this: the show, the last two episodes didn't save it. But it definitely helped it more than hurt it.
I think, and I haven't seen the show, but from what I've read, it seems like they use this, the Watchmen world, as a vessel to present this story in a digestible manner.
I would agree with that, but the problem is with that, in hindsight, is the last two episodes deal more heavily with the idea and concept of the Watchmen.
Yeah.
Than the previous six or seven or whatever.
I just don't know. Like we talked about this, I think, last week or the week before. That the whole Black Wall Street story is so intriguing. Why not just tell us that story? An HBO show on that.
I would have rather seen a show on that
and keep the Watchmen unbolted.
And the one thing that spoilers. Sorry,
no.
I'm going to get into it. I'm sorry. I want to talk about it.
I don't have HBO.
My biggest issue is that the Rorschach mask and shroud was used as a flag for white supremacy, And that's not who Rorschach
is. Yeah, no, that's not what he's in the books at all.
So
that's bizarre.
Without any explanation of that, that hurts. It's
so
personal.
They don't give a reason for why they take up his mask?
No.
Was it just because he fights
against... Not that I picked up on, anyway.
They don't mention him just because he fights against the police in the actual comic?
I mean, Rorschach is right of center.
Yeah, he is, but he's not...
But he's not that.
He's not that extremist.
He's not. No. He is an extremist.
But he's not a racist
asshole.
He's not.
You know? Like, that's what bothers me about it. Like Rorschach is probably my favorite character. Rorschach in Manhattan are probably my favorite characters of The Watchmen. And it's like, you took something that I love and somehow you made it impure.
Yeah, they kind of twisted it without any good reason for it.
They imbeciled it.
Mentally imbeciled it.
No, I didn't put that sauce on.
and the thing is if they would have explained it, like, these guys perverted, like, because, you know, sometimes I feel like spite is kind of about that, right? Like, I feel like sometimes I put this energy out there and people take this energy and run with it and manipulate it to fit their own means to make something perverse of what I'm trying to do, mm-hmm. right? If they would have done that, I'd have been good with it. But there's no explanation of it. It's just, but as far as I picked up on it, and maybe I missed it, you know, because there's so much going on and it's a fucking big puzzle and they don't start really putting the pieces together to the last couple episodes that it's like, I'm exhausted.
So are you totally turned off to a second season?
Yeah, I don't give a fuck.
Okay,
wow. I'm out.
Wow.
I'm out. Okay. I did my season. I did my time. I didn't let the time do me.
Okay.
You know? And I'm out.
So I imagine they will get picked up. It's pretty popular.
It was 9 episodes.
I don't know.
Hour long. I'd rather watch The Irishman 3 more times.
I haven't seen that yet either. I heard it.
Yeah, I got that on my list to watch.
Other than that, I watched Mandalorian, which we'll talk about, and I haven't really done much else. I did my best worst figure reviews and all that kind of stuff for the year.
Is it going to drop after Christmas?
Around that time. I've been plugging away. Like, I had this Four Dummies episode about Christmas as a collector.
Really? All right.
That I wanted to put out tomorrow. But then I got Goose today, so I have to get Goose out.
How did I get Goose before you did?
You did? Oh, I got Goose yesterday.
Oh, I got Goose yesterday, too.
Okay, I got Goose yesterday, but I wasn't able to fuck with it till today.
Neither. Or not at all.
So I got the review done today.
And
I got
too many figures. Too many Mescos for you.
Which one is Goose?
Skydive Fans Toys.
Oh, okay.
And spoilers... Best Fans Toys transformation since the Dinobots.
Really?
Fun.
Sweet.
Imaginative. Enjoyable. Like, stress-free.
I feel like Aerobots are pretty straightforward, don't anyway.
I don't know. Maverick wasn't. Maverick had some shit with him. You know, Silverbolt had some shit with him.
It's more complicated. The limbot, even as the G1 toys, was very simple. But this one
had some masterpiece moments. Mm.
Masterpiece moments in Transformers history.
Do you know what I mean? Like, those transformation moments where you're like, fuck, how did they, you know, black magic that shit in Ella Fitzgerald's words. But, like, when the shoulders, like, the arms fold into the chest, right? But in order for it to all be seamless in every single mode, you, like, slide them out a bit, turn them 90 degrees, slide them out a bit, turn them 90 degrees, slide them in, and then slide them in. Like, it's so smooth as opposed to, like, all right, you need 16 spudgers to get this piece free, and then, you know, so it's really good. But then I had to push the dummy shit back, so the Christmas shit's going to hit next Monday, right before Christmas, and, you know, so it'll still be in the right ballpark. But I'm juggling. I feel like I had nothing, and then I created all this extra content to pad the end of the year so that there was enough interesting shit. Yeah. And then as it's coming, then it's like new shit. Like, this got to get done. This has got to get done. And now I feel like well, fuck, I'm running out of days.
So you got to give time for Spite to drop.
Right. And that as well. The teaser dropped.
Yes.
Yeah, the teaser was dropped. Cool.
I got a lot of positive kind of feedback on that. And as far as I can remember, that's all. I'm still reading this Batman's Metal shit. I'll tell you what, I don't like it.
Yeah.
I don't like it. It's fucking goofy. It's goofy as a fuck. And I'm trying to stomach it, but I like the beginning. It reached the kind of here's the plot we're going to dump on your lap part. I consumed that, and then I was like, I'm not interested in this anymore. I don't like it. At least they did it in the middle instead of fucking at the last two episodes like The Watchmen, so that was nice. Shout out to JG, local guy. He's going to come by. He loves The Watchmen.
Really?
Yeah, so he's going to come by and
MJG? 8-Ball?
Yes, 8-Ball and MJG are going to come here because he's got a trunk full of all different type of pimp clothes in it.
Sounds about right.
That's is that some, like the thrift shop?
I've been to Orange Mound, Tennessee. Richard Hive of
Scum and Villain.
It's scary.
My
it's
man said scary. Trunk full of all different type of pimp clothes in it.
Are you going to come up? Is he going to come all, over? You guys are
all different types.
In the trunk. Is this going to be a skull affair?
No, it'll probably be a Patreon thing.
Okay.
By the way, 8-Ball and MJG have 35,200 subs on.
Hey, that's a shame, man, because they're a big deal to me. Ball Matrix wants to do a skull affair.
Oh, okay.
So I want to line that up, but I'll wait probably until after New Year. Like, all right, settle all right. Down.
Yeah, let me know.
If Copa hasn't taken over the world, the Copa Cabana.
I feel like people have forgotten about it already.
At the Copa. So did the stuff on December 10th elucidate
I didn't see any new...
I haven't heard. I figured you would talk about it on your channel if you did.
So there was some shit that came out a couple days earlier.
Yeah.
I'm guessing that might have been it because I didn't see any big scuttlebutt after the 10th.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think people just
No clarification.
A huge deal of nothing and then didn't talk about it.
Yeah. So we'll see. That's what I was trying to tell, like that whole thing where I was trying to tell these guys, like, man, just chill the fuck out. Yeah.
Like waiting watch, for the
like maybe it all will fall apart. But let's keep our fucking
keep your shit together.
Like let's keep our shit together.
It's like Y2K.
Yeah. Let's keep our shit together for just a couple weeks before we start really singing the blues here.
Yeah.
All the fucking Patreons are going up left and right, Joe. You can't be competing with me. I'm trying to do my own thing over here. Stay the fuck out of my lane. So with that, I think that's it. I might have some more shit to get into. But in the meantime, let's get into news. So let's go. We have, for one, your goose is cooked. Look. Top Gun 2 is coming. Mm. Okay. And there's one thing I want to say that I want to take my hat off about all of it. Because looking at the trailers and stuff. And I've been watching a little bit of the featurettes and all that. I don't know. Have you guys dug into that at all?
I've seen the trailers.
All right. So once again, Tom Cruise is doing all of his own stunts. Mm-hmm. And at his age, that's fucking super impressive. He's doing all of the the physical stuff, all of
he's flying too.
He's flying.
Yeah.
He's flying the jets.
Yeah.
He's also in one of the scenes, he is the jet, Joe. He has turned himself,
his
physical body, into the jet.
Is that like Team Machine back in the 80s
some
where he
comes
with the car?
Is Tom Cruise the 8th Blue Angel? I don't know if we need this.
He's a space angel.
I don't know if we need this.
That's a lot of people excited about this movie.
I know, and I'm not trying to rain on their parade. I'm not. I don't know if I need this.
But what if... Top Guns 2 is also the Transformers reboot, and they'll combine into Superion, like fan toys.
And Tom Cruise says,
"Fan toys." At least they would get one of the fucking jet modes right. Jesus Christ!
Yeah, you can see underneath the planes. There's these big blocks now.
But you know, I'm not sure if this can be good. Looking at the trailers, it looks good. I think it's visually stunning.
Yeah,
let me say that. Looking at the trailers, there seems to be absolutely no emphasis in either one of them as to the plot.
No. I mean, I don't think you watch it for the plot.
Just don't even worry.
It looks beautiful and it stunts.
Who's doing it? Michael Bay?
Are you one of those guys that watches porn for the plot?
No.
I do sometimes.
This is sky porn. That's what this is.
I don't need that.
I like a porn with a plot
sometimes. Sky porn is hard.
Sky porn is hard.
I believe that, Joe. No, that's a big thing though. There's in early porn, there were stories
it. That was supposed to be a sidebar, not a conversation.
And then in the 2000s to 2010s, there was no plot. It's just
Gonzo,
yeah. But now plot's coming back. You see more and more porn with plot or full feature length porn movies now.
You seeing it now?
Now, yeah.
I feel like now it's just three dicks in the ass.
No, that's also yes.
That's how I feel. Like
I watch that
today.
Too, but it depends on my mood. But you get both.
Wait a minute. Sometimes you're in a plot mode.
Hold on. Where's the third? Let me think.
No, you can get three dicks in an ass.
Is there a swing involved?
No.
Joe knows you can get three dicks in an ass because he's felt it.
Have you ever played Legend of Zelda?
Yeah.
You know the trident?
Oh, yeah. The gum?
Each triangle is the dick.
Triforce.
No, say that.
Triforce. Yeah. I'm sorry. Okay. Triforce.
All right. Brian, no. See the
Brian break. Fuck! I fucked my whole joke up.
The middle dick. It's got a shit in the deal.
Whoa! Like,
it's just
so to speak.
It's just between two dicks. I don't think he even feels any ass.
He just feels the other guy's dicks.
So there's like a guy on the bottom, a guy on top.
I get it.
And
yeah.
then a guy in the back just slipping in the middle.
So it's like a hot dog dick. In the middle. Yeah.
So are you excited about this Top Gun or what, Joe?
Oh. I got real excited about porn movie with plot. There's like so many parody movies now, and like
I know. Dude, I have bad fucked
and
upstairs.
Of these new like
it's terrible
new fucking porn movies parodies. The costumes are more legit sometimes than like the action movies. I feel like
I think
it's more accurate to like the comics.
Pirates started that trend.
I can tell you that on bad fuck, that's not the case. The costumes are way more legit than the Nolan film.
Is it more legit than Batman and Robin though?
No. Even right. Batman and Robin. Mr. Freeze's suit is way harder than anything and like, not way harder.
Does it have the big words that flash up like the old school Batman? Like no, does it say no. Skeet on the screen real big with a big bubble?
I wish. That would be great.
Let's make it.
That would be great.
Well, they made it legit. Just that one. There's an Adam West.
U-U-U-U-G-H.
Like the
or it's a Michael Jackson noise bubble. That's a throwback to an earlier episode.
The Adam West Batman porn parody, they had muffs in there. So I was like, oh, period.
Power
muffs. Accurate.
Period,
yeah.
As a period piece.
Yeah.
I hope not.
What is your, and this is horribly insensitive, what is your favorite colloquialism of a woman's cycle other than just saying
Black Jelly Day.
My favorite
Black Jelly
crazy.
Day.
My
favorite is
it's like usually the third day.
My favorite is just it's Shark Week.
Oh wow! All right,
yeah, Shark Week.
My favorite is we're not having a baby week, which is what we call it around here.
That's like, not how that works.
Wow. Like she'll come and be like, "We're not having a baby." I'm like, "Yay!"
Yeah, that never crosses my mind at this point.
Yeah,
I'm glad I don't have that stress.
I never had that stress.
Tell me more.
What do you mean?
Why don't you have that stress?
Because I only date girls that's on pills.
That doesn't mean
that
shit.
That doesn't mean that doesn't
that's
mean
also pro-abortion, like me.
I was going to say, you're talking about
I was working pills. At a pharmacy. I get Plan B at cost if I need it.
Did you ever sprinkle in oatmeal?
At cost.
Yeah. Sprinkle in oatmeal.
Some motherfuckers out here wholesaling.
There's generic Plan B now. It's real cheap.
Okay, but that doesn't mean it's just like. But I mean, there's all right. I'm not getting into that one tonight. It's a good vibes. I'm not getting into.
No, this is why that guy wants me to get off the show.
Here's
there's the one guy who wants Joe off.
At least one that I know of.
Here's my next note. I'm proud of this one. Shots Iger'd.
I'm gonna be on the fly on the wall when that conversation goes on, dude.
So Iger and Scorsese are supposed to have a sit down.
Saturday,
guys. This is it. This is the conversation. This is the conversation about The Rock.
But let me tell you something.
And Savage Dragon
and a hard crime movie.
I just talking some big shit. Fucking Scorsese coming there with two zips and fucking put him to rest.
To what?
Two zips.
Are you allowed to say that?
I think so. My grandmother's Italian.
Oh, fair. Okay. Yeah, but you know what? Mickey and Goofy are going to walk out from behind and just fuck everybody.
So look, for those that don't know, zips are what Italian Americans call Italians, proper Italians. So like when people on that side of my family would talk about Italian people, they would call them zips. Like it's like
them two dudes are going to walk in and you're going to hear doom 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 doom, 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 doom and Mickey Mouse Clubhouse and all the motherfuckers in costumes come out.
So he says,
machine guns.
If Marty Scorsese wants to be in the business of taking artistic risk, all power to him. It doesn't mean that what we are doing isn't art. I'm sitting down here talking to Adam, you know what I mean? I'm puzzled by it. If they want to bitch about movies, it's certainly their right. It seems so disrespectful to all the people who work on those films, who are working just as hard as the people who are working on their films and are putting their creative souls on the line just like they are. Bob Iger might need to relax a little bit.
I mean, listen, the guy that's the best boy grip, he's putting his all in it.
So
no matter what movie.
Now here's
on.
Where Iger goes for the kill. All right. Are you telling me Ryan Coogler making Black Panther isn't doing something that somehow or another is less than anything Martin Scorsese or Francis Ford Coppola have ever done on any one of their movies. Come on. My answer to that is yes. My answer to that is yes. That's just my answer as a fan of both. Both the Marvel films and the Scorsese films, that yes, what they are doing in Marvel is less than what Scorsese has done. Yes, that is my answer. It doesn't mean that it's not good. Doesn't mean that it's not important, enjoyable, that I do think it's art. I'm not the one saying it's not art, but I am saying it's less. Okay. Iger. Fucking catch an Iger by his toe, you know what I mean? So.
Wow.
So he says, when Francis uses the words "those films are despicable," to whom is he talking? Is he talking to Kevin Feige, who runs Marvel, or
Feige,
or Feige,
Fuge,
or Fuge,
Fjord,
or Fjord, or Fiji, or Taika Waititi, who directs, or Ryan Coogler, who directs, or Scarlett Johansson? So, like, that's a tactical choice.
Oh, definitely.
1,000% a tactical choice. Iger says, I don't get what they're criticizing us for when we're making films that people are obviously enjoying going to because they're doing so by the millions. Et cetera, et cetera. So that's kind of the gist of it.
I hope they live stream it.
Look, so let me say this. I think that Scorsese does come across as a hater.
Yeah, he does.
You know, I think the whole thing, he comes across as a hater. At the same time, I think he's right.
I don't disagree with him, but I think he's just piss poor timing. It makes him look like a bitter old man.
I agree. Yeah. I agree. But the, like,
and he may be.
I will say this, like, I can understand how it got, like, and I don't think that's the right way, because I think it's a stupid way to get that point across, right? But I can understand if this is just my opinion, but if you made The Irishman, which I think is better than every DC Marvel movie ever made.
Is it the best Scorsese movie?
No.
Okay. Is it better than Dark Knight?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. It might be better than The Dark Knight. It's not better than that trilogy.
Okay.
Same length.
Yeah, damn it.
Exactly. that's what I'm getting at. This movie is telling the story of one man's life. Okay. And Batman Begins is kind of telling, the Nolan trilogy is kind of telling the story of one man's life. And those two lives compare, the Nolan story might be better. But just one iota, one portion of that against the Irishman, I don't know. I think it's up for debate.
Marty, look up Eric Larson.
I feel like I call him Marty here. I feel like I would call him Martin if I ever saw him.
Martin.
Mr. Scorsese. Mr. Scorsese. If you're nasty.
If you looked at him and said Marty.
Eric Larson. I'm telling you. He probably would sign the right.
But you want to fuck a fajita or what?
Fajita was good.
Yeah, right?
That's
Wegman's marinade. That's the fucking key to that.
Are you
shit.
Fucking this?
Yeah.
What? No,
that's Wegman's marinade.
Do you doctor
out,
that up? Or you?
Nope. That's the fajita. No, that's the Wegman's fajita marinade, and that shit is out
that
for
is
blood.
That is amazing.
That shit is out for blood.
All right.
Anyway. So, yeah, I think he comes across as a hater. I also don't think he's wrong.
It's his ill time, like I said. It's just, I don't know. Was he doing press for The Irishman when all this happened, or was he just out running his mouth on the street? But I don't know.
So I think it was leading up to The Irishman, you know, so I would imagine that it was in the ether.
Initially, it was like 6 months out when he first talked about it, and then like
it's about right.
Yeah,
it's about
true.
Right. You know, but imagine that you make the Irishman, and that shit goes on Netflix. You know, and then you're going up against Ant-Man and the Wasp. Yeah. Like
It's not what the people want.
But and I don't think you say that as if it's a bad thing to be on Netflix.
No, but he put it in theaters for a hot minute.
I'm saying this.
So
just
saying
an
it's
award.
Different.
That's
awards.
Fucking. That, yeah. See, that's also like that's not a good look.
I don't like that either.
That's the Netflix plan though for these movies. They're gonna. I'd
but
be
it's
interested
also,
to see.
There's what, also a political play there too. I'm sorry to cut you off. I'll let you finish. But there's also a political play there too, where they're not trying to 86 the theaters out of the business.
Yeah, because the theaters.
Because Bright, the Will Smith shit came out, and everybody tore it apart. But there's politics there too. Where
yeah,
because
that should have been
with different movie theaters, and it's all, you know what I mean. It's all
that thing was supposed to be in theaters, and it didn't go.
But it's like, so it's the same thing, right? It's like. you know, Justin Bieber is going to sell 2 bazillion records, but it doesn't mean that the space shouldn't exist for.
No, it exists.
You know, it's a month. I mean, it's not even a month. It's like a day. You know, before they went to Netflix, like I can understand how if you're making quote unquote serious pictures, right? That if you feel like you can't even get a foothold in the door because these blockbuster, largely meaningless, you know, empty kind of things are occupying that space. I can understand it.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I think I'm just a hater. Mm-hmm. Like, can you list some stuff more Scorsese's movies?
Can I?
I know you can. Can you for me? Like, list some movies.
Oh, Goodfellas.
Okay.
Casino.
Uh-huh.
Gangs of New York. Departed. Shutter Island.
Shutter Island's good.
Yeah. That's the worst of those 5, by the way. But we'll continue.
I don't see that.
We'll continue.
I think we're talking to the wrong person because I don't give a fuck about his shit.
You say that. You say that now, but you also said that you love Casino.
But I don't, though.
But you said that.
But like, I watched
it. You said it. You're a contrarian. You said that last week.
Listen. I watched it once as a 13-year-old, and I never have the desire to watch it again. How much did I love it?
I don't remember it. So I don't think that,
I don't ever want to watch it again. No, no, no.
I don't think that replay value and love are necessarily the same thing.
Yeah, but I don't. So me saying
I love Schindler's List. I never want to watch it again.
Me saying I loved it was the wrong thing to say. Not what I said afterwards. It's because, like, if you think about it, if I could take those however many hours back and do something else, I would. The only reason I watched it then is because I had no choice as a kid watching shit with my dad. And I loved it as much as I could for something I had to watch. But that's neither here nor there. I don't care about his movies. Like, not saying they're not good objectively or whatever.
But you don't care about Ant-Man and the Wasp either.
If I had to choose, I would watch Ant-Man and the Wasp.
Maybe, but you don't care about it.
No, I don't. But
so what the fuck do you have? You don't even fucking skin in the game, Joe.
I don't, but I watch a lot more of the Marvel movies that I do care about than any Scorsese movies other than Shutter Island, which I loved. That I loved. I watched multiple times.
That's definitely one of his worst films.
So, but...
Like Last Crucifixion of Christ is his, right? Scorsese did that?
I can't remember.
So we're talking about subjective now, because what our preferences are has nothing to do with anything. Like,
no, I mean, we are talking about subjective, obviously. Yeah. But at the same time, it's like...
So, like,
to say that fucking Shutter Island is better than Goodfellas is,
I
like,
think so.
That's hard to hear.
But that's truth for me. That's my truth.
That's crazy.
That's not for me.
Yeah, but you, what did you like, Gears of the City? Didn't you like Gears of the City?
That was enjoyable. I only watched it once.
What Gears? What the fuck is Gears of the City?
I don't remember. I don't remember the name of the movie. It's cities out on wheels.
Oh, I saw the trailer for that. I was like, I'm never watching that shit.
You know, but like, that's the thing is that, like, the dude has created masterpieces.
And also, like, nowadays, just someone now, not maybe 20, 30 years ago. Now, why do we go to the theater? To be entertained. Not necessarily to think and be thoughtful and profound.
I think that the beauty of a good film is that it does everything.
It
can do everything.
Hang on.
It depends.
Not every movie needs to be a Swiss Army knife.
I agree.
Yeah.
So
I agree, but
I'd rather them be in compartments, goddammit. Because I don't necessarily need a Marvel. If I want to go see shit blow up, I'll fucking go watch a Michael Bay movie or you know,
Fast
Kevin,
and Furious
Kevin
25?
Fargy movie or a Fast and Furious 28. If I want some thought-provoking shit, I'll fucking watch some, like, Christian Bale starve himself or whatever.
But you know? I agree with you. They all should exist.
Right, they all need their place.
But
I can understand how a guy feels like he's being edged out when he's making high quality films
for,
like,
some people,
for the masses. Yeah. Rotten Tomato, any of that shit, and I guarantee you, the Goodfellas, Casino, Departed, all that shit is on a higher echelon than most of the Marvel.
And here's some others that he did: Cape Fear.
Yeah, I like Cape Fear.
Last Crucifixion of Christ. Is that Last Temptation? Last Temptation.
He did the remake of Cape Fear.
He did in '88.
Mean Streets.
He did Cape Fear in '91. Hugo, Wolf of Wall Street. I didn't realize he did.
Oh, I forgot he did Hugo.
Aviator.
The Aviator.
Yeah.
About the sunglasses.
None of that shit.
But did you see him?
No, I don't want to.
Yeah,
you've not seen Gangs of New York.
But
I don't want to.
Which is fine, but then your opinion on it is invalid.
No.
My opinion, it's not my opinion on whether his stuff is good. I said objectively, I'm sure
why
his stuff
do you
is
not
good.
Okay. Why would so
it's just my preference. Subjectively, I don't care about those kinds of stories, which is a me thing. I'm not saying they're not good. For me, I don't want to watch them. So that's why not everyone want to watch that shit.
Right, but I mean,
regardless of whether it's good or not.
But okay, for I agree. Release, but these are super high producing films. Right, these are not low budget films.
They did great in the theater too.
Yeah, for sure.
But that's what people wanted 20 years ago or 10 years ago, or five years ago.
But I think what he's saying is that maybe you're not even giving them a chance now. Is that maybe if you did give them a chance?
I mean, who's not giving them a chance? Is a question.
AMC, United.
So it's not the people. It's the company.
It's the politics. Yes, 100%. But that's what he's talking about. He's not talking about the viewers.
But he's shitting on Marvel movies. He's not shitting on the theater system.
Yes, I agree.
That's the problem. No, that's my problem.
Right, and I agree. I think that he's going about it like a hater.
Yes. Yeah. That's the problem.
I agree 100%. But I also I get where he's in. I understand that too. Yeah.
Being edged up, but he's sparking up the wrong tree.
I agree. He should be beefing with the politics.
Correct.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I'm saying.
Yeah. But you know, on the other hand, there's business shit that we're not privy to behind the scenes.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, and the theater game is changing. And I wonder what he knows. Yeah. You know, if I could pick the minds of the Coppolas and the Scorseses as to.
So I'll tell you this. That movie, The Irishman, got pitched to every major theater, every major movie house, and nobody would do it. And recently, they all came together and had some sort of round table, including Amazon and Netflix, and they all agreed. The head of Warner Brothers said Netflix was the only studio that could have done this movie. It's because all that de-aging was so expensive to do.
Oh, okay.
So Netflix did it. The Theater Owners Association was up in arms because they asked for a 76-day release, and they only wanted to give them 29 days for this movie the way Netflix rolled it out. And Netflix left a lot of money on the table. I don't think they're hurting for that.
Right.
I just think it's an interesting dynamic that the theaters that are, to be honest, controlled by these five studios are bitching about not getting this Netflix film more time in the theaters when they wouldn't fucking back it to start with.
They wouldn't fund it.
So fuck you. It's on Netflix.
Yeah, no, and I think there's a part of that too. Like, yeah. But I agree that I think it's much more politics, and I think that he is lashing out the wrong way.
Yeah.
But I'm also saying that I understand his disposition.
Yeah.
Like, I understand being Picasso and being mad that Rob Liefeld is making $1 million. Do you know what I mean? I get that. But like, the dude is.
Yeah, I mean, I'm 100% on board with his movies being objectively good. I'm not arguing. Mm.
Just good combo, though, Mac. God bless. All right.
Shutter Island is badass.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
No, it's not bad.
I said badass. Yeah. I liked it a lot.
But I want to clarify that. I'm not saying it's a bad film. I'm just saying when you mentioned Goodfellas,
it's not nearly as
Gangs of New York.
Well done as
Last
his other
Temptation
stuff.
Of Christ. The Last Temptation of Christ is crazy. It's basically the devil comes to him, like with the deal on the cross, and he takes it.
Really? So he switches the
yeah.
The
he takes
in the
it.
Bible.
He takes it. He's like,
A what if?
Yeah. Fuck all that. This sucks. This cross bit. They didn't tell me about this. This sucks. Give me Mary Magdalene and a little hut. I want the Thanos hut.
It's too fancy.
All right. So that was a fucking. See, I like that. I like that shit. I like that shit. Big shoes to suck.
Moving right along.
Tell me more.
Netflix Dracula series.
No, I'm
trailer.
I gotta see it.
So I'm gonna watch it. But I watched the trailer. Fourth. Old Dracula, I'm on board. Young Dracula,
yeah.
I'm not on board.
Who is that guy?
He's too. I want to suck your blood.
He's too. He's too much like.
I remember seeing that.
Like the old Hammer films version.
Yeah. He's too like.
He's too much. He's very much like Udo Kier.
Oh, easy there, man. Sorry.
Does he have a medallion on his neck?
He may not.
Is it a Rockefeller?
But in spirit, he has a medallion.
He's very much like Udo Kier when he was younger.
Death Row.
Maybe they purposely bring that version back because we haven't seen that version in a while.
Yeah, we haven't seen that version since like the 70s.
But I mean, we've seen
a lot of sparkly vampires. We've seen badass.
The kind of impaler vampire. Yeah. Like, and I agree, it's time for a Dracula story. But I don't know if this is the one.
I don't know, but like, it's different.
I was going to ask you if you're going to watch
it. It actually has a Bram Stoker's Dracula vibe.
Yeah, it drops on the 4th.
Yeah. And it's in that time, right? Like it's of the days of old, like them streets on Broadway. You know them little cobblestone streets?
Yeah, Victorian.
Whenever,
with the umbrella and the big dress.
Whenever I would drive down Broadway, like before you get to Fells Point, I had shoulders hit a shotgun to me and sort of be like, hey, you know where we're on? And I was like, what? And he'd be like, the streets of old.
Cobblestone.
I'm going to have to check that out.
I'm going to watch the first episode.
Yeah. Are you going to give it three?
Three?
I'll give it three.
All right.
You know, I was recently told that if you have a half-ass idea, you can probably get it on a streaming service now. Mm. You come to somebody with an idea, because there's just so many opportunities to put content out there.
Yeah.
Especially
YouTube, at least.
If it's a, maybe. If it's an original idea, you know?
Yeah.
Not a cop-out.
Not a copa.
I didn't recognize the actor that played the younger version of him. I was like, who is that?
Me neither. I don't know, but I know one thing for sure. Yvonne's to suck your blood. Which made me, so I watched it, and I was sitting there with Laura while I was watching it tonight, and it made me think about Once Bitten.
Yes.
Do you remember Once Bitten?
With Jim 80s, Carrey.
Jim Carrey.
That was Jim Carrey's first movie.
We got to watch that. We got to watch
that. Put on the list
that.
Of the movies we're going to watch that we're never going to watch.
That we're never going to watch, man. Yeah, yeah. We got to watch
like
that.
Like Gangs of New York.
But here's the thing about, I was talking to Laura about this. This is a side little note, but I think it's interesting. There's a lot of these movies I used to watch as a kid that had these adult themes and shit to them, but I never realized it. But my kids
pick up on it.
They realize it.
Yeah, they realize
you know, Jane is asking, what's a virgin? Yeah. No, it's a Virginian.
No, it's a version.
Yeah, it's a version.
They have an aversion.
They say she's a version of something.
She's a version of a whore.
Yeah. Let me tell you something. You don't want any parts.
Come on.
God.
I'm sorry. Okay, so, but like I'm watching, I'm thinking about the Once Bitten, and you know what scene popped in my mind? So the lead countess, she's a vampire. Like old type of lady that smokes Mad Marlboros, but still sexy.
What, was that with a stick, with a stem?
She probably does in the movies, but at home she gets busy. You know,
take them goddamn filters off them camels.
Yeah, she has this assistant, this African American gentleman who is seemingly a homosexual. Right. As I watch this as an adult, these are the tones
I pick
up. In
which movie is this?
Once Bitten. Okay. This is an 80s movie.
I'm familiar
So I'm picking up on it, right? As an adult, I'm like, oh, yeah, it's a gay guy. All right, cool. So he goes into the closet to get her.
Is it Lauren Bacall?
I don't know. She smokes mad cigarettes.
I think it is, yeah.
To get her an outfit to wear. And she's like, Sebastian, which should have been my cue. I feel like, not for nothing.
We got Sebastian Shaw.
He's gay.
Sebastian the Crab.
I'm kidding. I don't know. Yeah.
Do you know what the tagline is for the Once Bitten poster?
Oh, tell me, please.
Well, there's two. The tagline under Once Bitten is a tasty comedy. But the quote on the top says, Mark Kendall just found out that his one night stand has been around for centuries.
What year did that come out?
Samuel Goldwyn Jr.'s Once Bitten. 85.
Okay. So she says, Sebastian, come out of the closet. And my man says, I've been out of the closet for decades. But I
wouldn't have picked that one. That
I had no fucking clue. No. You know, like I like none of it. Like it just went under my radar. Yeah. And they talk about virgins and shit. Like she's looking for a virgin. She needs to have like. Blood of a virgin, yeah. You know, to keep young.
Yeah, like Elizabeth Bathory.
Yes. 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 Nice name drop, yo, too, by the way.
Jim Carrey straight up looking like he's auditioning for The Matrix.
Yo. So this scene right here. See the girl all the way to the right in the tuxedo, like the Zatanna outfit? She is the countess. She's the vampire. The girl all the way to the left in the white is his girlfriend.
Yeah.
During this scene in the movie is this 80s jam that's tough as fuck. It's like, hands off. He belongs to me. Hands off. He's my private property.
How do you remember that shit?
I'm telling you one last time.
Now I'm going to have to dig for this now.
The boy is mine.
Now I know where you guys
are. It's tough as fuck.
Oh, so it's the boys in mine of the 80s.
Yeah, of the 80s, yes. Yes, good record.
Boy Is Mine on the 90s was good, too.
It's not bad.
Brandy
and Monica.
Yeah.
Dang, that takes me back.
Yeah,
yeah, man.
You know what Monica song I like the most? Maybe that's just why I love you so much. I feel like if you put that on and you're on a Ferris wheel, you're going to get a little love.
Pinger doesn't work right now.
He's yeah, like, any idea what the name of this song might be?
I think it's called The Boy Is Mine or Hands Off.
Okay, by Maria Vidal.
Probably.
Okay.
All right.
She
is known for her hit single, Body Rock, that reached number 8 on the U.S. dance charts.
Number 8
on the U.S. dance chart?
Body Rock.
Not on the all-time
chart.
What year
was that?
It was the theme, dance charts.
It was the theme to the film Body Rock in 1984.
All right. So here's our next note. The presidents, Christopher Columbus, Martin Luther King Jr., and Keanu Reeves, what do they all have in common? They're all getting a day.
I celebrate Keanu Reeves Day.
So Keanu Reeves is dropping, or not Keanu Reeves, but
the studios
are dropping Matrix 4 and John Wick 4 supposedly on the same day in 2020. There's no fucking way. I'm going to tell you right now, there's no fucking way. Mark my words.
Back to back. Just watch one movie and then go hop over to watch the other movie.
There's no fucking way.
Double feature.
I'm not seeing either one of them, but yeah, I'm sure they'll be fine.
You can go see Bill and Ted?
Yes, that I will.
That'll come in August.
Bogus Journey.
That's going to be a long day for me.
Bogus Journey is still better than Matrix 2.
I'd rather watch Matrix 2 than any Scorsese movie. And that's the truth.
I'd rather watch Bogus Journey than any anime ever, Joe.
That's probably true, too.
I'd rather read a graphic novel version of Bogus Journey than any manga.
Ooh, I don't know if I can say that. Maybe watch the movie.
Actually, I would be interested in reading the Akira manga.
Yeah,
not good.
No,
it's long.
I know it's long,
and goes way off the rails.
I'm sure, but I like that's something that every now and then in the back of my mind I think about. Like, man, you probably should give that a read.
You should give Berserk a read.
I would. I'm down to read that too, but I got to get through Coruscant Nights first.
So. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this book out.
We didn't say shit. We didn't say shit as you.
Oh, this is why I'm not invited to Brofest. See, it's all coming together now. It's Coruscant Nights, isn't it?
I need to know you to know the narrative of Jax Pavin, so you need to get busy on those books.
See, both of you probably get together and talk about Deadpool, omnibuses, and
Star Wars books that Bobby won't read.
Yeah. Our next note is called Endgame.
We've gone too long without talking about Star Wars.
That's true. We're coming up.
Hey, you made up for it last episode when you started. Yeah, like, yeah. Two-thirds of the episode.
But it's the week.
I know.
It's the week every week now.
So, Endgame. Marvel TV shuts down. How do we feel about this?
I don't care.
It was going that way. Anyway.
It was going to happen. Yeah. Disney Plus shit. And I wouldn't be surprised if some of the key creative players in the Marvel TV gets picked up for Disney Plus.
I think most of the street level Netflix stuff will end up being on Hulu.
Street level, the Daredevil. You know what I mean? You know the vibes.
Right? Yeah, man. We got to cut this with something before we put on the street.
Luke Cage, Yao Ming.
That'll all be Hulu fodder.
Hey, Marvel Studios, he gone. Yao Ming.
But it was only a matter of time. All right, Les. About time, comrade. We are getting Red Sun.
Oh yeah, I can't wait for that.
Cartoon,
dude.
Right?
Looks
good.
I am.
Did you guys all watch the trailer?
I have not seen the trailer yet, but I'm missing the Red Sun Mezco. And I know I need to get it quick because that's probably going to
happen. Yeah, that's so. They didn't give a release date, though.
Just make a call.
Make
a call. Or,
yeah, I don't know.
Despite putting the trailer out yesterday, they didn't put a release date.
They said
2020. They did not give a date, which is unusual. Usually when they put the first trailer out, they have a date in mind.
They're
finishing up the animation
now. I wonder
now.
How close to the... And I haven't read the book, so...
No? Yeah.
Well,
no. it's a short read.
My question...
I don't. Adam does. Yeah.
My question is... What I can't remember from the book is they show the one scene in the trailer where there's multiple Green Lanterns.
Which was great.
Is that in the book? Because I only remember there being Hal Jordan in the book.
I only remember Hal Jordan as well, but I haven't read it.
I haven't read it in a few years.
When I first started getting into DC, Adam let me borrow that book to expose me to Elseworlds, and I was like, this is fucking dope. But yeah, I don't know.
Because I don't remember there being all those Lanterns.
Shit looks good, though.
Yeah, it does. Awesome. I want to know who's doing his voice, because it's definitely not anybody who's done it before, I don't think.
Yeah, I like it, though.
Yeah, it's got to be Russian.
There's a great story. I don't think I can tell it.
Is this a $10 spot?
It involves Adam's brother.
Ooh.
And Russians.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to tell it.
I wouldn't do it.
I'm not going to tell it. But I feel like if he was here, he would tell it. But it is a fucking classic.
Yeah, that's something that he can probably only tell.
Maybe episode 300, he can come on and somebody remind me, have him tell the Russian story. It's
amazing.
All right, Mandalorian. Who saw it?
Hey.
Okay.
Saw you guys.
Everybody.
I'm way behind.
I think I saw it three times.
Okay, let's get into it. How do we feel?
Great first. A through F.
Okay.
So this is episode six, right?
I don't know the number.
Well, no, excuse me.
Chapter.
It's chapter.
Chapter. Chapter six. Chapter. Yeah, that's
don't
true,
confuse
that's true.
The masses.
There's going to be total seven or eight.
I think it's a total of eight, and I think this is six.
Okay.
I think you're right.
So you still got two more. So it's going to end next year.
It ends...
Or if it ends
in 2 weeks.
Okay.
C minus.
B.
B plus.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So we're all in a similar space. It's nothing.
Well, episode is similar. We're like our trends are the same.
Yes.
You're like a grade and a half below ours every time.
Has everybody had a favorite so far?
Number three
was your favorite.
Number three is my favorite.
Which one's that?
I'm sorry. Where the Mandalorians fight the bounty hunters.
Yeah. Where he.
Oh, yeah. That's probably going to be my favorite. I mean, I haven't disliked an episode. Okay. I've watched them all multiple times.
I have only disliked one. I dislike the sniper one. Okay. I dislike that episode. I don't like it.
Is it the kid's earring? Take you out of it.
I like that one a lot.
Yeah. I hate that character.
Oh, he's trash. And
And I feel like they could have done so much more with her. That I'm just generally disappointed by the whole thing. The only thing I like about it is that the droids are in the bar, and that's playing off my nostalgia. It's member berries, you know.
Member,
you know. Like well, that. For me, for that one.
Yeah. So on the new one, we get Bill Burr finally.
It's funny because he always
Bobby
shits
shows
on
up
Star Wars.
On set.
Huh?
He does.
Bobby shows up on set.
Yes, yeah, Bobby shows up. According to those kids at Inner Harbor.
Hey, yo, there go Bill Burr. Yo.
Some similarities there.
Well, it's funny they knew who Bill Burr was.
I thought he did great.
I did too. He's playing himself, so he's like Cameron in Paid in Full. But
I don't know. He's a little
in DMX and
he's
Belly.
I feel like he's goofier in real life.
He's
like more
DMX
serious.
In every movie he's ever been in.
He's pretty serious. I feel like he's pretty like even though he's funny in real life, he's pretty serious.
Serious, but funny at this, with a serious. I don't know.
Except when he does Sherry's Berries. My favorite part of that entire episode is two parts.
Uh-huh.
Spoilers. One is when he says "nice shoes."
That was fucking.
That was great.
Is that an in joke for something he does or
no? It's just that like the fucking rebels in the
those have those white fucking boots.
They just dress like assholes,
yeah.
You know. And he's like, "Nice shoes, matches your belt."
You know, and it's like a cool like just side commentary.
Yeah,
dialogue.
I like that.
It makes the person seem real.
And then when them fucking X-Wings show up, like here's the thing about what Disney has done with the X-Wings, and I'll give them this credit: the Disney era in the X-Wing. When you watch the original trilogy, the X-Wing is just like, it's just part of it. It's just like, yep, you have
Y-wings,
red swords,
B-wings?
You have blue swords, you have X-Wings, you have TIE fighters, it's part of it. The Disney era, whether it be Rogue One or The Force Awakens or Mandalorian, when the X-Wings show up, you always get the perspective each time from people outside, not inside. So like, in Rogue One, it's the guy standing on Edu, you know, trying to go for the save the father or assassinate the father, depending on who you are in that story. And the X-Wing show up, it's like, oh, fuck, because you see it from their perspective.
Mm-hmm.
In Force Awakens, it's the guys on the ground, you know, that are fighting the First Order, and they're held captive, and the X-Wings show up over the water. It's like, oh, fuck, you know. Mm-hmm. And then in The Mandalorian, it's the guys inside the thing, and the X-Wings show up, and they're like, there's nothing we can do, you know.
Are those X-Wings?
Yeah. It's like, fuck, you know, because you never get that perspective in the original trilogy, so they just seem common. But to play it from the outside in, like, fuck, if you saw an X-Wing show up, it's fucking on. It's you're over. Like, unless you're an Imperial Army, you're out of play. You know, the only way that you had to really compensate with this is if you have a fucking band of TIE fighters to send after them.
Yeah.
You know?
Because they're superior to TIE fighters.
Yeah. So I love that shit. Like, I love that. Dave Filoni's one of the pilots, which was fine.
Oh, the other two pilots are the two other directors as well.
There you go. Yeah.
Oh, sweet.
And I have real mixed feelings about...
Talk to me.
...the line.
Talk to me.
I wasn't... Well, I don't know why... In my head, mm-hmm. when I replay it, I hear, I wasn't a fucking stormtrooper. But he didn't say that. But in my head, when I replay it, I see Bill Burr saying, right, I wasn't right, a fucking right, stormtrooper. Right, right, right. I don't know why, and it feels right.
Right, I agree.
But I have a mixed feeling about it. One, I like it a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It seemed real. It was good acting chops on his part, because it's mm-hmm. a funny fucking line.
He does a good job.
Yeah. He's
playing himself, but he does a good job.
But still, I didn't...
He's believable.
Yeah, exactly.
I think he's the best of that crew acting-wise.
Yes. I hated the fucking Twilight.
She's terrible.
So let me...
She's terrible.
Okay. Maybe it's direction.
She's too over the top.
Maybe it's direction.
Maybe.
Hang on. Hang on a second. Does that portrayal from her and her brother, does that give you a different headcanon on the Twi'leks in general now? That they're not all these sexy dancing...
No, because she's still kind of sexy.
No, yeah, she is. I didn't realize...
Joe's already made up headcanon.
I didn't realize that fucking ugly dude next to Jabba was a Twi'lek.
Oh, so that's on you.
I didn't know that.
So yeah, I didn't know you. That. I didn't know it was either. I actually done a little
because
research.
He only had one thing out, but the other one was behind him.
Yeah, he's the
He's ugly as
fuck. You talk about Bib Fortuna.
Bib Fortuna, yeah.
Flex on you.
But also, I don't like that line because, like, it solidifies that stormtroopers was bad shots when they're not supposed to be seen that way.
And I think that's they're just supposed kind of to be, this.
They're the elite troops. There's the regular Imperial army, and then they're the stormtroopers who are, like, the special forces.
Well, then there's just special forces.
And they only apparently can't hit you when you have fucking plot armor. That's the only reason they don't hit you.
When you don't have what?
When you have plot armor.
What's plot armor?
You're a major name character. They don't hit you.
Oh, plot armor. Sorry, I didn't
like that.
But they hit everything fucking thing else. Like, remember when we watched Rogue One, we enjoyed the part where, like, oh shit, Stormtrooper seems dangerous, seems serious. You don't want to fuck with them.
Yeah.
That's how they should feel.
I agree.
Yeah, because like, they're supposed to be the SS.
So, like, I have a mixed feelings about that line. Like, it was really well delivered, and it was a...
Well, there's too many bald guys in the room to mention the SS. Yeah.
and sorry. Me. Sorry.
You're going to get us flagged.
I'm not Japanese, though. So yeah, it's a great, like, you know, like homage to fans because, you know, everyone, we always make fun of how stormtroopers can't shoot.
Right.
Or can't.
Right. Which is, I mean.
So, like, I have mixed feelings about
it. Well, look, I mean.
So that's my thing with this show is I think most of it is an homage to fans.
Well, Dave Filoni directed and wrote this episode.
This
and
one.
That's why they said it's very heavy handed on the fan service.
Because he also did another one.
That what I read was this is the first one he's written
he
and directed.
He did the fucking the bar one. He did the one I don't like, I think.
No, I don't think so.
He did either that one or the one with the ATST. He did one of those.
That was
two.
The one. It's the one with the ATST.
Okay.
That was
so those
which
are the,
makes sense.
So those are the two weaker ones to me in this whole series.
Okay.
Huh. Surprisingly.
So
I'm a Filoni, like, you know, but Kalem's fucking with my head. Kalem's gotten
he's not a Filoni
Kalem's
fan.
Gotten in my head.
Yeah.
Let's call Kalem.
Kalem's not a Filoni fan?
That's cool, Kalem.
But Kalem's a major Star Wars guy.
Yeah, he
but
is.
He doesn't like
well,
wow. I'm surprised.
Calling Kalem.
Oh, Kalem. He put a Star Wars sauce on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's the Star Wars
thing. Star Wars sauce on it.
Oh, what? What's
we're going to get to the bottom of this shit.
So far, I like Rebels, too. So, like, I like all his shit.
Oh, it's like weird. California, so it's like he's probably eating dinner.
He's 3 hours behind us.
Or he's, he's in a car somewhere. It's like 6:45. He's stuck on his way home.
He's stuck on.
Hello there.
Hey. Hello there.
Kalem.
You are on Nerd Rage.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Really? Okay. So we got a question for you. We're having a Mandalorian discussion.
Duh.
All right.
And I was just saying how you have started fucking with my head a little bit about this Filoni guy. So
maybe a little bit. Yeah.
All right. So make your case. And I need you to reach down and grab them balls. I want you to say it with confidence so that you because I'm reading what you're saying. Now's not and I just made a comment to the people that I'm buying into what you're saying. So
okay.
now's not the time to sound indecisive, sir.
All right. So this is not force sensitive where I have to be nice, right?
Correct.
Okay. So I think Dave Filoni is not as great as everybody thinks he is because I think what he does is he appeals a lot to nostalgia, and he tries to play upon that, right? So, like, I don't like what he did with the Clone Wars. I don't like how he, like Darth Maul, right? I don't like how he brought him back, kind of wedged him in there with Rebels and Obi-Wan. Like, that should have never happened. But I think what that guy has done is made a career of taking what we love about Star Wars and kind of doing, like, a Cliff Notes version of it, right? So for me, with The Mandalorian, when we were talking Chapter 5, like, all the Mos Eisley stuff, like, that to me was him kind of not doing his best writing.
So that's his episode.
So five is his. I'm mistaken. Okay. Six okay. was
five was his standalone. Like,
okay, so that's been the weakest one. I feel like.
Yeah,
I agree. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
because that was the whole thing where he likes to play that remember type stuff. Like it's you always talk about
the
like, that
member berries. Like, the member berries.
Yeah, yeah.
I agree. Like Maul seemed like he would be dead. He got cut in half, but I really enjoyed him in Clone
so
Wars.
So I do
like
too. I love him so in Clone character. Wars. I love him in Clone Wars, and I love what they did with him in Clone
like,
Wars.
Him with Obi-Wan and killing Sabine
and fucking Savage. Like I like the name is a bit on the nose, but I like the cultural aspects of going back to Dathomir and finding his brother and all that shit. Like,
but do you like the whole recon of that too? Because he went back and changed Darth Maul's origin story too to fit within that particular episode. Or
well, was his origin story from the fucking EU?
But there was nothing in canon, right?
It was EU. Like it was novels. There was two novels and a comic. Right?
Yeah,
but I mean, like
that was like during the days where everything was like being.
Caleb, you and I can kind of speak in shorthand about this, but a lot of the listeners had this kind of skewed view of what the EU was and don't realize
skewed
they,
view of the EU.
Oh, dude, did I just get on my Anakin?
You got your bars out, man.
but they don't realize that the EU is a trample over itself, fucking all the time. You know, like
that's the problem.
Yeah. But
and to me too, like what Filoni did too with the Mandalorians, like because again, like my Mandalorian stance is usually coming from like the Old Republic, right? Like they were Vikings, basically like space Vikings, right? They look like predators, you know.
Right.
They had like a code of honor. They would go up against the Jedi just to fight, just to prove that they could fight.
Love it.
And then
I like
when
it too. I always thought they were
Filoni got a hold of them, he made them basically like. Here's what I like to me, like Filoni made them like Alderaan. Like they made them like royal castes and stuff with like, like when I watch in the Rebel stuff, I'm just like, dude, this is not Mandalorian to me. Like it's cool that to see them, but it's not like that true Mandalorian to me, you know?
Well, that's that faction, the true Mandalorians, and right,
yeah,
and Death Watch, and they are the factions fighting against the changes. They want to stay. They were true old way.
Yeah, I'm good with that too. I'm good with that, too.
Like, there are still true Mandalorians out there. Because I agree. I don't like the pacifist Mandalorians. I feel like that's throwing all the Mandalorian identity away and being something else.
Right.
But it's cool there was one thing that he did, right? There is a civil war.
There was that one episode where it was Palpatine versus Maul versus Oppress, you know, and they had, like, that.
Classic episode.
That
was like awesome. Classic episode, by the way.
Yeah, and that was, like, you know, the Pablo, you know, the Picasso, like, relief on the wall, right? It showed, like, the Mandalorian history of them fighting the Jedi. He sprinkled some of that in there, but I don't know, man, like, that dude just, it's always, like, Cliff Notes to me. Like, it's just, like, it gives you a little taste, it's kind of vanilla, and he kind of strings it about, but then, like, everyone's like, oh my god, he's so great. I'm like, there's something about it, dude. Like, I don't know. I can't put my finger on
but
it.
But you're loving this show, right?
yeah, I am.
See, I'm on the border of saying I don't like it.
Yeah.
I'm right on the cusp.
I can get that because it is turning into like
Freak of the Week.
Right? Yeah. Yeah. Like to me, like 1 through 3 tells a story.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
4, 5, and 6, he's on the run. He's trying to get his bearings. I get that. Even I kind of need, like, okay, what the fuck
are we doing? And why the fuck does he care so much about money?
Because he needs it.
For what?
Run his fucking ship.
For fuel. Covers the fuel, Bobby.
Just sit down some the fuck where.
He's running away from people.
From who?
All the people with the fobs.
There's people in spaceships.
We're not seeing them.
You saw the dude in the spaceship.
The dude in the spaceship, the one before that, the sniper. The guy who
the sniper wasn't after him.
That Kara. Well,
I thought it was a baby.
They're not after him. They're at, which one?
Which
the sniper episode? No, they were after. Like,
no, not no, 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 no. He's talking about with the with episode Cara Dune. With the ATST.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. He couldn't stay there. Go somewhere else.
So he has to keep running. That's the thing.
But it's like,
because the next episode, he's being chased by a tiger. He needs money to keep running.
Well,
you know?
Yeah,
and it's like,
I feel like they just turned it into a plot
device. How do you buy bullets and fuel?
But I feel like they're just turning it into a plot device that just has something new every week instead of an overarching story.
I agree, but I'm just saying, he doesn't
need money. Bullets,
you need money.
Right, but I'm not saying he doesn't.
Also, not lasers, they're plasma.
And I'm not saying he doesn't need money. I'm saying explain why. Explain why. Tell me why he needs the money and tie that into something that actually fucking means something. Calum?
Yes, sir.
We're going to have to talk at length at some point, but today's not that day.
Yeah, I'm actually here with my mom right now. So
tell her I said what's up and Merry Christmas.
We're hanging out watching Christmas movies, so it's all good.
What Christmas movie?
She's got Santa Claus 3 on, so, you know, I'm just...
Calum,
flip that out for Die Hard.
Calum, I'm losing faith in the whole family at this point.
Dude.
Tell her to flip it out for Die Hard.
I'm losing faith, too. I'm like, you know what? We just need to... Never mind. I'm not even going to go there. But,
all right, man. I love you. Take care.
See you, Calum.
Thanks, everybody. See you guys.
Okay. Chapter 6.
Yes. What about it?
So let me tell you what I liked. I liked the X-Wings, and I liked the... Okay. The droid was cool.
Yeah. He was.
The droid was a cool character. Yep, I like Bill Burr was a cool character. The Twi'lek could have been a cool character, but she was too over the top. The devil guy, let me tell you what irritated me about him. Okay. When you're 6'3", and you bump into a guy that's 6'2", and you call him tiny, your dick is small.
do you know who played that character?
I do not.
It's Clancy. I don't know.
Clancy Brown.
He was the
C. Brown.
Yeah. He was the guard in.
He's in a lot of things.
In Shawshank is what you might know.
Oh, Clint. Oh, yeah,
and he also does like 915 voices on SpongeBob.
And he's first Highlander.
He's been in a ton of stuff.
He's in Lost.
He's been
around. Oh gosh,
he's on Starship Trooper. He's a sergeant.
Oh yeah, that's right. He's in everything.
Joe's over here with the deep cuts. Movies that he will watch.
I like him. I like him in things.
I didn't like him in this.
No, I didn't like his character.
Okay. All right. So I'm on board there.
Bill Burr's...
The brother, the Twi'lek brother, I didn't like him.
And I'm okay with him.
Okay.
Like, I don't know. It's not, maybe not the acting, but the character itself. It's just like a
I'm on board there. I'm on board with the character, not the portrayal.
Like Mark Boone's character? You know, who did he play in the Dark Knight trilogy? Did he play Harvey Bullock in Batman Begins?
Tell him to eat
a falafel.
So here's my
Bobby Elvis from
no, he
Sons
played
of
flat.
Anarchy.
He played Flash.
Okay, that's
they don't eat falafel.
Yeah.
Yeah. They here's my problem with him. Him and the girl, the Twi'lek,
mm-hmm.
and the devil guy.
Mm-hmm.
They all overact.
I don't think Mark
Boone did.
I do.
Tell me more.
Just a lot of that. You know how it was, Mando, in the old days with the ba-doo.
No. I feel like that's supposed to be an act, because he's a phony. He's going to stab him in the back.
Then you should see that.
We saw it by the end.
No, like, I'm saying, but like, it. So either he's a bad actor or he's being insincere.
If
he's being insincere, then Mando should have picked up on that.
Well, he did, because at the end. Even at the beginning, he was like, oh, you mean gratitude? Remember who was when he's.
I feel like he would have been better prepared if he really didn't trust them. Because they definitely got the drop on him.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, it was. Here's something.
Because he didn't know who was releasing.
Here's something that they don't really delve into that they don't show on screen. The droid says, I found out some more information about the Mandalorian, because he sees
Carl Weathers
talking smack on the little thing. So we don't know what that information was, but apparently at some point they're like, we're gonna lock the Mandalorian in this prison, and then he got the drop on them.
It was cool to see him in kick-ass mode.
Yeah, when
like,
he's fucking
this
with
is, I feel like this is the most kick-ass Mandalorian we have
so
seen.
Where did he go? I told you, and he's behind him, and he does all the cool stuff.
Yeah,
but he also got everybody like alien style.
I agree.
One thing that bothered me from a costuming standpoint is Bill Burr looked like a shitty cosplayer that didn't have time to finish his costume. He needed a chest plate or some armor or something.
See, I feel that way about the devil guy.
Yeah. I feel that way, but the devil guy didn't feel that way about Bill Burr, because he seems like
a regular guy in that universe.
Yeah, but why? Okay, you're a regular guy in the universe. Are you going to wear some sort of fucking armor at all times.
Maybe.
I would.
But armor is, well, unless it's Beskar, is useless.
I don't know.
Joe's armed with too many YouTube videos at this point.
Stormtroopers get shot all the time.
We cannot face him.
This is Joe true. Knows a lot of details about costuming.
Yeah, no. I told Joe, I was like, man, you got to relax because Star Wars will let you down if you start holding it to the details.
Going back to whatever, the guy who owns a junkyard or whatever. In the beginning, it was insincere until the point it was like, well, your ship is the only reason why you're here. And then and then the Mandalorian was like, and he was like, what's that look for you? Gratitude? I was like, that's the real him.
Yeah.
Like, not being a shyster. That's how I read it as.
I mean, I'll go with you on that.
Just like at the end when he took the money and he gave him the money. He's like, oh, we don't ask questions.
There's so much overacting in all of it that it just seems like, it just seems like it's like, a wider spread issue. I'm with the fan bullshit explanation. I'm with it. I do the same thing. Like this meme here of Obi-Wan has taught you well when Luke is on the high ground.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's all overacted, you know, like, right?
No, but I'm saying that's fan bullshit explanation of why the high ground means something. It's just George Lucas lunacy.
Yeah, but I'm saying like the overacting was in all of
coincidence.
Right? But it's overacting. Yeah, I mean,
in this era, true?
That's impossible. Why does his lip do that in that scene? That's not true. That's impossible.
He was stroking out a little bit,
maybe. And I think the car accident he was in real life.
Oh yeah,
because he was in like a serious car accident.
That wasn't no Wampa attack. That was
even the prequel.
So speaking of the Wampa, right? So. Side note, but Star Wars related. So you've been, I know you're more into like the technical details of the, you know, but like, are you into the biological shit at all? Like the animal stuff and the, like the habitats and
some of it. So I haven't gotten deep into that yet, but I'm into it.
So when they cut open the Tauntaun and they put Luke in it, you know why they did that? Because it's lukewarm inside.
I was waiting. That was a good long form setup, man. Joe has left the room.
You belong to me, hands up. You're my private property, hands up. I'm telling you one last time. Definitely getting flagged. Bro Fest is mine.
We had to take a quick little intermission. Oh, that was the wrong thing.
Yeah, wrong thing.
We had to take a quick little intermission.
That song, along with many others, will be available at the end of the show. A playlist available in the description.
Has that worked out so far? Have people
for one person
about it?
At least
one person.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's move on to 9. We kind of know how we feel about this episode. It's mixed reviews, but you guys enjoyed it more than I did. It's fine. I admit it's fine. Let me say this real quick. Mandalorian Chapter 6 is a good story in and of itself, but it's not helping the series.
I'm not holding the series up to high standards in the beginning, remember? Okay. I was just enjoyable thing to that
correct.
Star Wars.
Correct. Just throwing my two cents on it. That's my main issue.
I mean, that's B for what it is.
Right.
Not for like fucking masterpiece theater. That was just like stop motion with Masterpiece Transformers.
Dude, I tell you what.
Masterpiece Theater used to mean something else.
Dude, Masterpiece Theater, when that guy was chilling out on that fucking leather chair.
Oh, yeah. You could smell the pipe smoke.
That dude, I wouldn't fuck with him. That man meant what he said what he meant. Episode 9, heading into it.
Heard about
you
it.
You and I are going to go see it birthday season.
I think that's maybe more than a quarter, depending on what season we're talking
sounds
about.
Sounds like so, Bro Fest, dude fest, fest, Homie Fest,
birthday season.
It's birthday. SSSZN.
BS.
That sounds about right.
Fair.
How do we feel?
I want to subjugate your point with my point. Okay. My point is how much hype is on Star Wars now. How much hype would be on this movie if this Mandalorian shit hadn't come out? I don't know.
I said that a few months back when you said there's not enough rollout. I'm like, I think Mandalorian helps with the rollout.
Well, the rollout has been heavy recently. I mean,
28
TV spots.
I mean, who's seen them though? Do you watch? Have you seen them?
Every single one.
Right, but have you seen them on TV?
I've seen a lot. I've seen a lot of, at work. There's like a TV on all the
time. Okay, that's fair. Yeah. That's fair.
And I've seen a lot play. Like, because the only reason why I say that
I
is
haven't
because I'll be in the middle of a conversation. Like, hold on one second. And then we watch the TV spot, and I get back to the conversation.
Hey, here's a question. So Rey, right?
Mm-hmm.
You guys have heard of her.
I'm familiar.
So she's not the last Jedi, we hope, but she is a Jedi.
I think she's the last Jedi.
Is she a Jedi?
Did you see the Fortnite clip? Do you know about this?
Yes.
Did you watch the Fortnite clip? Why the fuck is this girl with a goddamn lightsaber and Jedi powers still carrying around that fucking stick? And it's so awkward, like that scene where in the Fortnite scene, she's like struggling to keep it on her. I'm like, why are you still carrying this fucking stick around?
It's like a safety blanket. It's keeping her safe all these years. She can always have a lightsaber.
She can always remember to go. It's, I have to remember Jakku.
Jakku.
One quarter portion.
Is there her sidearm? Giant sidearm.
Let me tell you where my thoughts are with this right now.
Mm-hmm.
And this is going to go out to the general audience the day that we see this movie, but to the Patreon folks, they'll get it Wednesday morning. I have zero doubt that I'm going to enjoy this movie.
Well, you already know everything about it. Even if it's bad, you would enjoy it.
I have zero doubt that I will like this movie. I know I'm going to like this movie.
That warms my heart.
What I do have worry about and what I do have concern about is how I feel with this movie being a bookend to this story.
Mm. So they say.
That's what I'm concerned about. I'm not sure if the story components of this movie will wrap up this saga for me in a way that I find satisfying.
Yeah.
And there's no way to tell until
that's
I see
all,
it.
I mean, it's always a problem with... Well,
it's hard to close.
But, and that is like a subjective thing too. Like you can't please everybody.
Sure. You know? Sure. And I have a theory that they're trying to please a particular group. There's been some reviews that have come out, most of which have been positive, overwhelmingly. Right. At the same time, the ones that are like, even the ones that are positive and some of the ones that are negative, they're like all positive for the reasons that I'm not interested in and all negative for the reasons that I am interested in. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like the people that are like saying negative shit about it, I'm like, that's how I feel. You know, and the people that are saying positive shit is like, that's what I want to avoid. they're like, you're going to love it. It's going to make you remember. You know, and I'm like, I don't want that. I want to go forward. Time to let old things die.
Yes.
All right. So, with that being said, let's get into some questions. We got a few in an email, and then there was...
Got a shit ton everywhere.
I have a question.
Okay.
Best lightsaber fight in a movie.
In a movie?
In a Star Wars. any Star Wars movie.
Anakin, Obi-Wan.
Okay.
In episode 3? Yeah.
Definitely not 4.
You'll never.
Definitely.
Just clarify.
You'll never win, though.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's like Darth Maul versus Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan.
That's up. That's in my top 3.
Dude,
that's like the only part of Episode 1 I actually like.
Of course. As soon as those doors open up.
Yeah. What about fucking Dooku versus Obi-Wan?
That's not in my top 3.
Grievous versus Obi-Wan.
Not in my top 10.
Does that even count? Oh, he has lightsabers. He's just a lightsaber.
I mean, I have to go with Darth Maul.
And Qui-Gon.
Yeah, and Qui-Gon. And
Obi-Wan. I mean, that's like three fights together.
My favorite part of that is when he does that back spin and then grabs the droid head with the force and throws it into the controls on the door.
They open
up the door behind him as he continues to fight them while moving backward. That's my favorite part of that whole scene.
That hits a number 2 for me only because... he would definitely kill both of them in real life. There's no way they were a match for him fighting style wise.
Obi-Wan is a defensive fighter.
Yeah,
he is, but
Obi-Wan is no slouch. I think that my beef with that is that it seems like when Obi-Wan jumped up and over, it seems like Darth Maul had all the time in the world.
Exactly.
It's the editing of it. It's like,
edited together, the way it's shot.
I mean, dude, it's the same way Anakin jumped over Obi-Wan.
Dude.
It's like, I don't dismiss.
No, that's faster. That's faster. Because in episode 1, it's almost like Maul's like, yo, you can't just be jumping up all over. That's not them the rules.
Them the rules.
I had the high ground.
So Kelly brought up a good point watching it. She said, they do all that fucking fighting, and then Darth Maul bumps him in the nose and fucking kills him. Because that's what happens. I mean, and it's the editing, the way, because it's not edited quick. It's like bump, and then he's like stunned. Yeah.
Well,
and he gets
you ever got hit in the nose? Smarts.
I understand.
Fuck you all
disorientating.
Up.
Yeah,
you got the pain shooting through your nose. Your eyes fill up with water.
That's right. But those midichlorians should be able to work through that shit.
Now, for all the things that I have to offer, that's as good as it's going to get, but it's never going to get that good again.
So what I'll say about that fight is, think about what you thought of a lightsaber fight before that movie.
Before right,
that,
you saw right,
that,
right,
like, that was right. a game changer.
Changed the game.
Changer,
changed the game.
Yeah, it was. It was totally but, set the expectations.
If I was to think about like my top three, the Vader. I mean, the well, Vader is technically accurate. Obi-Wan fight of Episode Three is my number one. Qui-Gon Maul, it's my number three. Mm. And
what's number two?
It's probably, and I know this seems like a cop out, but it's probably the Luke Kylo fight, and it's just because of what it means to not fight and win.
Actually, there's one I'm forgetting, and it's
short as it was.
Kylo, it is short.
Kylo and Rey versus
quid
the
quid pro quo. It's all of it. It's like the whole. It's the energy around it.
No, I enjoyed it a lot. But just,
the Kylo and Rey
fight is
correct.
So
no, I understand. Yeah, it's just the meaning. Yeah, the meaning.
Kylo and Rey against the Praetorian Guards is a pretty
that's
fucking
a
awesome.
Yeah, that
there's
that
there's
awesome,
some there's some moves in that
when she catches the fucking right in the middle of the screen. And the music hits like it all
oh,
hits.
Oh
like,
shit!
Yeah. One of my favorites is when he goes, he catches it and goes on and off.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
a good
yeah.
shot. That's a very well choreographed fight.
Agree. Except like there's all sorts of flaws and shit in it. But
oh you're, well,
but,
you know.
But you know what shit happens.
It's edited.
You
know. It's all edited.
Sorry,
we have questions.
Yes.
Only like 3,000 of them.
Well, we need to pick like three of them.
I
got to get my 3 hours in. So let's.
All right.
I still got to go to Chevy Chase.
What?
I have to work tomorrow morning, so I want to skip traffic tomorrow morning by going there tonight.
Oh, wow.
Collecticon says, if there was a podcast that was updated daily that only played what people said about you when you weren't around from the previous day, would you subscribe?
What? Alex, you've lost your fucking mind.
If so, how often would you listen? Do you think it would change your behavior? Wow.
Wow.
I'm going to say no. Because I have a comment section that I don't subscribe to.
Yeah, because that you already have that every day.
Yeah, so I'm going to say no. I would let it be. I would let it be.
Yeah, that's a hard pass for me.
Yeah, I have to pass.
Yeah, no.
You wouldn't have any friends or family, probably.
But I will say, like, I do take into account.
That's awful.
When people, when I get a real objective criticism, when people are like, hey, man, it's too, like so I've heard some people say, like, the Tiger Track shit is funny, but it's too fast. You know, because like, they're really trying to use the scale.
Right.
So I've tried to let it linger a bit. Mm-hmm. You know, like I do take some things into consideration. Right. I'm not just operating in a vacuum.
Right.
But at the same time, there's so much super hateful shit that I have to like protect my psyche at the same time.
Jeez.
You know?
Yeah.
All right. James G. Hey, guys. Saw the FB post. Oh, God. He sent a ton of questions and none of them are rapid fire.
Holy fuck.
Are you ever going to have your family breakdowns of who can stay or who can go? You had a couple of good ones.
Yeah.
You've been holding like the MK Ninjas and Spider. Hell, you can probably do the Mountain Dew family too. So many trash flavors.
I don't know. I love them all.
You're right. We'll try to get back to that. We got to make an effort to get back
we
to
gotta
that.
We got to write it down. Like which family to go through.
Yeah. What's your guilty pleasure food? I know under the right circumstances, I'll eat a whole bag of Ruffles and dip before I realize it. So mine is definitely spicy nacho Doritos with fucking Tostitos cheese dip. I'll heat the cheese dip up. If it's my preference, I'll heat it up in a pot, and I'll fuck the whole bag up, and I'll fuck the whole cheese up. And I know when I look at the empty cheese jar, that's when I start thinking, like, yo, you can't be living like this.
You're a monster.
You're fucking your
life. Your body doesn't let you know beforehand that, hey, this is not a good idea.
No, my mouth is telling me don't listen to it.
Damn, dude.
So to speak.
Yeah, always.
Yeah. Right. What about you?
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Oh, that's a hard. That's a hard one.
Any cereal, I never know when to stop.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
What about Mucilix? Do you know when to stop on that one? I bet your asshole knows when.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
All right, I probably say peanut butter M&Ms.
I like all brands.
You're a little sweetie.
I like sweets, obviously, but like. Peanut butter chocolate M&Ms, man, I could almost nix an entire bag and not throw up. It's crazy.
So this is what you gorge yourself on? Is that what it is?
Just guilty pleasure food.
Oh shit, I'm worthless on this.
He said I eat a whole bag of Ruffles and dip.
How you do a whole case
that's
of White
good,
Claw?
That's good shit.
I love some Ben and Jerry's, to be honest.
I do.
Which flavors?
Chunky Monkey's my jam.
But I'll tell you what, the little pint, that's not enough for me.
No, it's one serving, though.
That's not enough for me.
Oh, the little pint?
No, the little one. That's
a serving. Oh, no, not the little one. No. Like the big the pint, the regular pint?
Like, yeah, those are supposed like to be three servings in that
yeah,
shit.
I'm like, man, fuck
ain't no
this,
fucking
this,
three
yeah,
servings.
I need three of them.
Yeah.
There was
a whole thing.
There was a flavor that they do limited runs. It was some Bob Marley themed one that was out over the summer. It had like graham crackers in it.
Yeah,
and I had a Ben and Jerry's when we were in Reston at the Ben and Jerry's scoop place. It was a 7-layer coconut cookie or
I
something.
Should have gone there.
That was fucking bananas.
Yeah,
man.
You should have thrown your $8 store
gelato in right in the trash.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Joe, just for you, buddy.
What's up?
Merry fuck kill. Or I guess in this case, Pilot Joyride Blow Up.
Oh.
Pilot Joyride Blow Up.
Some motherfucker named Goof.
G-O-U-F?
Yeah.
Mm. Goof or Goof got custom. That's two different things, my brother.
Zacko 2.
Okay.
And Dom. We all know you'd pilot a camper.
Camper, yeah. That would be my favorite.
This dude is speaking nonsense right now.
Speaking to me, man. I would kill a Dom. It's ugly. It's like a fucking fat, goofy thing. I know it's supposed to be powerful, but no thanks. I would... Fuck the goof. It's special.
It's dude, we need special. To put that in a soundbite.
Never
fuck
say
the goof.
My man said, I'd fuck the goof. It's special.
Dude, it's got an
we need a clip of that at the beginning of the show. I fuck the goof.
It's got an electro whip, bro.
It's too close to Christmas.
What is happening in my hood?
And I would marry the Zaku too because it's Old Faithful.
Pinkerton.
Oh, boy.
What was your finisher in your wrestling days? And it's spelled wrestling.
Of course it is. I actually had a sit. I did a sit down, modified sit down powerbomb. I called it short bus.
No big deal. Speaking of goofs,
I had a goof troop. Of course, I used a choke slam, and then the last
mental
one.
Mental imbecile. Okay.
The last one I did was a modified quacking driver 2. Any of you wrestling wizards want to look that one up?
What the fuck?
Sounds like a combo
me
breaker.
Talking crazy. Did you hear what he just said?
It sounds crazy.
Yeah, I can show you how.
Is
it
a combo breaker?
No, it's
a combo breaker.
You know, real shit.
It's a fisherman hook suplex, but you hook the far leg instead of the inside leg, and when you go up and around, and then you sit down. Basically,
if you can see him illustrating it with his hands, it's what like he's playing some hands? Bizarre instrument.
That's right.
He's like, "Tell me a yak."
I'm the
harp on your shoulder.
I'm the opening act for the cantina or something.
Yeah. Skullface, a lot of young kids are media driven these days. Have your kids ever approached you about following in your footsteps regarding their hobbies, like YouTube reviews, etc.? Jaina has approached me about doing animation YouTube, and I have told her, let's see how this cop of shit shakes out. Do you put hot syrup or cold room temperature syrup on your pancakes?
Hot.
So I like it room temperature or cold.
Yeah, because you
on a hot pancake. I like the contrast.
No, I go to they give you Waffle House. You can ask for hot syrup. They put in a little cup and they'll microwave that bitch for you.
So they make
fucking hot syrups and shit.
They make Aunt Jemima that changes colors when it's hot in the
microwave. Yeah. I've never seen the bottle.
Yes. You can also just put it in a coffee cup and nuke it. And I normally just mix butter in with it too because I'm a heathen. So
you have to pet sit for a fellow co-host. Which one is it, and why? And would you do it in your home or at theirs?
You don't even have. Well, our pet sits Smeagol.
Easy. I'll give you the ash box.
Yeah, I'll hold on to it for a week or whatever.
Back in the day, if Alabama and Smeagol were around, let's say that for Alabama, for the sake of conversation.
I'll pet sit Pinkerton because got chunky cats.
So I would take Butters.
Just Butters? No, you got to take both.
Hilarious.
No, it wasn't both. It was one.
It was one?
Okay. Yeah, I would take Butters because he's chill and he's fat.
I feel like the other one liked me more.
Really? Think so.
Butters sometimes yells at me.
But I'm going to tell you that.
He did. Butters got all in your business the other day.
Who would you take?
One of his cats just because they're easy to deal with.
See, you never knew Bam.
I never knew Bam.
Bam was never knew Bam either.
I just don't want to pick up hot steamy poop. That's why I don't have dogs.
But I don't want anybody to shit in my house either.
It's in a box.
It's in a box and it's dry.
Yeah, sure.
In the house.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't want that in the house.
I shit my
in
house.
The yard?
I like it outside.
I shit my house. You shit in your house?
Yeah, no, I flush it. I don't let it sit.
You know, you can train a cat to use a toilet.
Yeah, I'm not fucking with that either. That's wild shit.
It's called It's called a city kitty.
Oh, no, it's not.
I'm sorry. Look it up, Bobby. It's called a city kitty.
I don't want to look it up.
I feel like I want to perform one of those.
Joe's getting ready for the next act.
Tyler, the collector, said, my new favorite Star Wars podcast. Love the amount of good Star Wars conversation last week. Joe, welcome to the Rebellion. We have saved a spot for you. My question is, what are you hoping to see in Clone Wars Season 7?
Oh.
Are there any specific storylines you want to see finished? Any character arcs you want to see finished or improved upon? Do you see any difficulties with what you hope they accomplish with what's come before in Rebels? And then he says, personally, I would have loved to see how the turmoil between Obi-Wan and Darth Maul played out. The ending in Rebels left me wanting more. Also curious to see how the remaining Jedi recover after Order 66. Insert Bobby impression here.
It won't, though, right? Because Clone Wars run up to Episode 3, not after.
Correct.
Clone Wars ends before Episode 3.
Correct.
Correct.
So Season 7 has to end before Order 66.
So it's supposed to, from what I hear, it's supposed to run through Order 66.
Oh.
So it runs into
that changes everything.
Okay. That's the rumor I heard. Okay. I don't know if it's true or not.
That changes everything because it would run in tandem with the movie.
So the truth for me is very simple. All I want from Clone Wars is more answers as to what happened to Ahsoka.
Isn't she in Rebels?
Yes, it doesn't answer the question as to what happened in between the two.
So you'll have to forgive me because it's been a long time since I watched. Where is she the last time we see her in Clone Wars?
She left, right?
Okay, I remember that. And we don't know what happened to her. So
I want...
Dave Filoni loves him some Ahsoka. And he can tell. I mean, that's the story he's done with.
A lot of people love Ahsoka. I love Ahsoka.
I love
Ahsoka. Do you see our little thing on your Disney Plus? Is Ahsoka?
No, I haven't.
Our profile?
But Ahsoka's fucking dope, man. She's a great character.
I mean, it's just a whatchamacallit. Just a wish list. I would like to see Ahsoka and Ventress does some shit together. That would be awesome. But that's just you know, wet dream kind of thing. I don't think it has anything to do with anything. So I don't think that will happen.
Is this a porno plot?
Stay on target.
Yeah. I had to think about it for a second.
100%.
I said, wait, she's legal by that point. Because she was only 15 when you made her.
But yeah, the question is what does she do? You know, like, aside from Dark Disciple. No, Dark Disciple doesn't even deal with Ahsoka. Like, no, there's an Ahsoka book. I haven't read it. There's an Ahsoka book.
Is it a canon book?
Yeah.
But so I would like to see what happens to Ahsoka during the Clone Wars.
Yeah.
I mean, during
Order 66 is like, where is she at during that? How does she feel during that? Knowing that Vader turned. Like, where is she at when she learns that Anakin becomes Vader or has an inkling or the Force connection or whatever that Anakin has made the fall? Like, what happens to Ahsoka during that? Like, that's big questions.
I thought that's covered in Rebels. Like, she meets up with him in some time.
Yes, but no, but that doesn't
answer. After?
Yes.
I want some self-reflection of her, like, shit, if I didn't leave, maybe he would have.
Yes.
Yeah. Maybe he wouldn't.
Is this my fault? Yes.
Is it my fault for going?
Like, he asked me to stay and I left him.
Because all, like, that's why I fuck with Anakin so hard. It's just people after people leaving him.
And it wasn't even his fault, really.
I know
like,
the vibes.
He was trying to help her, but, like, he couldn't. Yeah.
I was 3, Joe. My mom never hugged me. Will you hug me, Joe?
If you come to Bro Fest.
That's all Bro
I'm not invited to fucking Bro Fest. What about you, Pickerton?
I think Ahsoka's story is probably the one that we probably want to see the most. I'm speaking broad strokes here. We know what happens to Obi-Wan. We know what happens to Anakin, but we don't know what happens to her. That's a great point, so... I think that's what I'd probably like to see out of it.
What? Because it's been a while since I've watched Clone Wars, and I guess at this point we'll just save the Facebook questions for New Year.
We got a Paul C question.
We got a Paul C question that we'll ask. But
don't mess up my fellow yellow.
I'm sorry,
yellow fellow.
But what's the state of all of the major clone players at the end of Clone Wars? Like, where is Rex and Wolf and
Fox? Rex is around. Rex was, part of. Yeah. Rex is in Rebels. I know that.
Right. But I mean, no, I'm not saying that they died, but like, where are, like, is there any of those stories that's like, man, I want to see more of those characters?
No, I think it was pretty, there was no loose ends.
Okay.
Like, after Fives, when Fives got found out about the chips and it, you know,
right.
And he got dead, there was no more like clone centric storylines.
Quick question about the clones. they had accelerated growth rate to get them to
double
fighting. Do they age out the same way? So they have
double. So like when 50. They're fighting, when they're fighting, they're 18 physically. They're fucking 9 year olds mentally. Mm. Think about that. It's a whole army of 9 year olds. That's why they're so fucking loyal and fucking naive and fucking I love the clones, man. But like yeah, so it's double rate for their entire lives. So by the time they're 20, their bodies are 40 years old. That's part of why like their empire has retired them. They didn't make any more clones, and they're starting to get old. And they just started
stealing babies.
Yeah.
Real quick, my wife said she likes episode 1 better than episode 2.
Really?
I found that to be very odd.
I like episode 2 better.
She likes podcast, not podcast. She likes podcasts, obviously, but pot racing. Do you like pot racing?
I actually didn't sit with her.
She's like, I like 3 laps.
She's still listening to the show.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know if Emma's still listening. I haven't heard anything. So, Paul C. Really enjoyed your responses to my audible orgasms question last week. I do have some issue with the Star Wars sound you chose, though. If you were going to choose a Star Wars sound for when you come, the three acceptable options are the Wilhelm scream.
What's the Wilhelm scream?
It's like it's in every Star Wars movie. It's like the stormtrooper that falls.
Oh,
the
Ootini
or the or the X-wing laser blast sound.
I want the sad R2-D2 beep. Yeah,
what about the worried R2-D2?
Or what about R2-D2?
That's the build-up noise to when you're about to.
When the super battle droids slam him through the and just screams.
What about just Roger, Roger?
Oh, yeah.
Roger, Roger. Rogered.
I don't think Laura would dig that. Roger, Roger. Anyway, this week's question is more of a follow-up to one I asked months ago. In the lead-up to Avengers Endgame, I brought up the similarities between Endgame and Episode 9. You guys predicted that Endgame would do better than 9, pretty much across the board. With the popularity of The Mandalorian and of Jedi Fallen Order, do you still think this will be the case? Some add-ons. There were a lot of people who said that they would be done with the MCU after Endgame. Did they? Do you think...
You did.
I did, but I don't think a lot of people did.
I said that. I was done with it after Infinity Wars.
Right, but that's not what he's saying.
I'm assuming there are people who said that also.
I feel like I haven't bumped into many.
No.
Have you bumped into anyone who's been excited about new Marvel movies after?
No.
Like that says it all right there. Everyone's excited up until the climax, so to speak. And
right. They got to build it back up. Yeah. I mean, it's a lot to build. But Doctor Doom is supposed to be the bad now. Like that's a decent one to work with.
It's pretty good.
There were a lot of people who said they would be done. Okay, do you think the same will be true for Star Wars after Episode 9? I haven't really heard much about people claiming being proud that they will bail after this. If you think that people will stick with Star Wars, what do you think is the difference between the franchises? There's plenty of additional world building, merch, video games, etc. for both. What makes one different than the other? So,
I think it's 40 fucking years is the difference.
Yeah, I think it's different, and I think that like the fact that Clone Wars is right on its heels.
And Mandalorian's hot right now.
Yeah, I think people are stuck in.
And with Disney Plus,
I think with Disney Plus, I mean, one, the movies are front and center for you constantly. One, if you didn't already have that, weird flex, but okay. And two, I think they're going to constantly have something new in front of you.
And for different age groups, too.
Right,
like the
exactly.
Cartoons,
my kids, they only care about the sequel trilogy and Clone Wars.
So
that's it.
Are they watching
that generation?
Yep.
Have they watched that new show that's very child?
Resistance?
Yeah, we watched it. They weren't really into it.
Okay, I don't even know anything about it.
Yeah, too young.
They're just kind of peppering characters in left and right.
Because they've watched Clone Wars. They've watched Rebels. They're like, this is fine, but this is not.
This is for children.
Yeah. But it's like even they know this is.
They feel like they're being pandered to.
This is shooting low.
Yeah.
You know? Finally, I was thinking about how there wasn't much of a media ramp up for The Mandalorian. We've definitely criticized them for not putting out any Baby Yoda merch. Solo, Episode 9, etc., etc. This has got me wondering if they perhaps don't treat each Star Wars product as its own thing. Maybe Disney is just treating Star Wars as a collective property. What are your thoughts on that? Maybe they're relying on Mandalorian or Fallen Jedi as a way to get people excited about Star Wars and thus Episode 9. It's not the traditional way of doing things, but Star Wars isn't the traditional franchise. Episode 9 did still manage to sell out really quickly. So episode 9 is doing really well, like, you know, trajectory.
Pre-sales.
So I think it's going to be a word of mouth thing. Like, if people say it's great, I think
then more people will go.
You know, and I think it's going to appeal to a wider masses. I think that that's
for better or worse.
See, here's the problem, right? Episode 7 came out. Most people liked it, but the big criticism was it's too much of the same.
Yeah.
So episode 8 comes.
It's very different.
Very different.
And then it's very divisive.
And then people are like, "Well, I don't want it very different. I only wanted to criticize that the other one was too much the same, but I don't want it. Yeah, but I want it the same. I don't want it too different." And then now you had to kind of walk it back. Is my guess.
Yeah. And well, I mean, seems like the same criticisms were made for the original trilogy.
Yeah,
that
8 was too different. I mean, 5 was too different.
So but using that trajectory, mm-hmm. big words, I think that we'll get something similar to Return of the Jedi here. There's going to be.
I agree.
I think,
but they're saying this is dark. Like, people are saying, like, this is.
Is it PG-13?
I don't know.
Think so.
People are saying this
to the internet.
People are saying that this is the dark Star Wars. Like, this is a
good. That's what I want. I just want to see.
I think Palpatine is going to get loose.
Really? Okay.
I want to answer Paul's question.
It is PG-13.
Oh, okay. So it's going the Marvel film route.
Because Switzerland, like, put a PG-17 rating on it or something. Like, you know, they have some fucking weird ass fucking, you know, IKEA rating on their shit. And, but they were like, for darkness and vampires.
Darkness and vampires.
Space vampires.
Yeah. And I'm guessing that, like, I think I know what that means. I'll just leave it at that. I gotta get a guest on this fucking show that wants to talk about spoilers at some point.
you got 3 fucking days, and we can talk about it all.
Come on,
hold your shit together.
You know,
it's not even 3 days.
This is why he can't sleep. He's got nobody to talk to, and he can't sleep.
He's calling Tyler.
But you know,
morning.
I don't know. I think that is an interesting point. If everything Star Wars is constantly promoting everything Star Wars,
actually, I'm sorry,
that's your point. You mentioned that earlier.
All 3 of these new movies are PG-13, so they can't all drop 1 F bomb.
Dude, what would that be like? Just like we're getting 1 in before it's all said and done.
It's gotta be Palpatine.
I'm going to tell you in all honesty. I don't give a fuck, Ray, about any of your bullshit. And who the fuck is this hairdryer droid you brought?
So, I don't know any spoilers, but if Palpatine does come back, I hope he just rips Kylo a new one. Like who are you trying to be? You're never going to be. I don't.
So, did you see that trailer? Did you see that clip? That little link I sent?
No, nope. I didn't watch it.
Dude,
I didn't watch it.
Come on. Nope. You got to give me this.
Nope. Don't want it.
I don't
want anything. I just want a movie. That's all I want. I just want to watch the movie.
You guys are fucking killing me.
I have gone so far. Hit up Ty.
You have so many people you want to talk to.
I mean, I'm not getting in. I'm not getting in it.
But it's just like, it's not even spoilery.
No, I don't want to see anything.
But see, what you think's not spoilery might. It's because you already know all this shit.
That's only one major spoiler.
So that I agree with, but having known that the laugh is in there, this doesn't spoil anything.
Maybe they just find some old holograms.
Yeah, it's just old holograms. It's Tupac.
It's Jim and the holograms with Tupac featuring Tupac and Michael Jackson.
Fuck!
How would Michael Jackson sing the Jim song? I wonder. Jim is adventure.
Every voice you have ever heard.
I'm gonna leave it at that.
I don't know if we answered Paul's question or not. I don't think a lot of people are gonna jump off of Star Wars.
I think that he's raising an interesting point. That what if everything is constantly moving the machine?
Because it's always in public consciousness. Then
correct.
Especially now that Disney Plus is out. You constantly...
I can make the argument though that Baby Yoda has done more for this franchise than anything up to it.
Yeah, I am true. Star Wars now. I will tell you. I'll tell you an interesting story real quick. I have a former coworker friend that I still talk to occasionally. He lives in Orlando, and he goes to Disney quite often. I said, "Hey, have you gone to the Star Wars shit?" He's like, "What are you talking about?" It's like they tore down a bunch of shit at Hollywood Studios and built the Star Wars World. Oh yeah, I guess I know about that. I was like, "You haven't gone?" He's like, "No, I don't give a shit about any of that stuff." Like, what do you?
Star Wars? I have some coworkers.
I mean, he's like,
I have a coworker
just so unattached to anything. It's just
I have a coworker that just said to me, like, dude, are you excited? Star Wars is ending? And I was like, it's not as you understand it.
Yeah.
But yes, I am excited, as I am excited with all things Star Wars. And he was like, I'm going. And I was like, are you? And he's like, yeah, my son wants to go. But he doesn't give a shit. This dude, he's going to walk into this movie. It's going to be like the only Star Wars movie he's ever seen in his life.
Because, are you serious?
Like, yeah, but he's got like a son that wants to see it. You know? So like, they're going. Cool. You know? So like, good. But how does he walk out of the theater? He's like, this is fucking strange.
More, he's going to call you right away and say, what's this mean?
There's like 10 billion guys in this fucking thing that have no explanation as to why they're there. Everything is the Emperor from episode 6, as far as I'm concerned, in this fucking movie.
So, on to his point, the machine, not Raul. Shout out to Raul.
Shout out to Raul. Also known as the sex machine.
I'm going to let you sort that one out.
That's fucking awesome.
In certain circles.
I think... So,
dude, that is wild.
At the end of
that's my guy.
In game ends, and that's there's nothing behind. I mean, obviously, there's a huge comic book world out there, but there's no more media right in your face. And I think the rollout of this movie right behind it. I mean, maybe people that haven't watched The Mandalorian are like, oh,
which comes out tomorrow, by the way.
Right, it comes out.
Do you want to come through tomorrow early before you go to work?
I won't even be here tomorrow.
Yeah, he's going there tonight.
I'm leaving tonight to go to... Yeah.
A jet plane? Don't know when you'll come back again?
What time does it come out in the morning?
Wait, why? Why? Today's
I think
Tuesday.
Midnight.
No, it comes out tomorrow. Because of the movie coming out, they didn't want to cross streams, so to speak.
I got something to watch tomorrow night. That's why I watch where you're
in the movies. I think that the machine here is going to just drive people to this Disney Plus to devour Star Wars, and there's so much content there, and that wasn't necessarily there when Endgame was in the theater. It wasn't there, but now I think that may just be the direction that they're going.
I mean, a lot of Marvel TV shows are going to be coming out soon, right?
Yeah, I'll be excited for that. That's
the only difference, is like Star Wars got his stuff rolling before it.
Yeah, that was the big push.
See, Marvel, if they had that stuff...
It's always going to be.
Yeah.
If they Marvel had show started before Endgame came out, then I think they could have kept the momentum going.
Did you forget about the boycott, though, Joe? There's a Star Wars boycott after Last Jedi. People don't want to watch it anymore.
No.
Yeah, not at all.
Are you sure?
The sales are suffering.
Are you sure? Because there's YouTubers that have told me that nobody's going to see it.
No, it's
going to
be empty
Pretty
theaters.
Sure a lot of tickets sold out.
All right, Phil, if you say so.
I'm just going to walk in and just grab a ticket.
Yeah, Joe's going to walk in. Just sit down next to Bobby.
No, we're going to birthday season.
What the fuck is birthday season?
Dude, you're in it. You don't know what it is? You're living that shit.
Right now.
You fucking know the vibes.
Hey, it's his birthday quarter. It
will be on Thursday when I show up, because he's getting his present a week early when I show up for Star Wars.
No, man. I'm hoping Laura organizes something.
I don't know.
I can come by on your birthday, too, because I have a half day. But for Star Wars, that's when you're getting your thing, because I need to get...
You fill the roses.
What?
The roses pizza that I usually get on a
birthday.
That's the one you told me, right?
I thought you were talking about an Outkast song.
I'll tell you about Guns N' Roses.
Guns N' Roses, I'll take that too. We could play Guns N' Roses while we smell roses, and you give me some roses for my birthday while we eat roses.
I got to try that pizza still.
Fun fact, I once used Roses by Outkast as wrestling music.
No shit.
It wasn't my choice, but I was in a tag team.
The fact that it's a tag team is funny. Shout out to the rest of the Cool Table Network. We have Shattercast Uncut. We have Enter the Realm. We have Beer and Bolters 401k. We have Stasis Lock. We have Toy Detox, I think. We have Building Up to It, Fresh Communications, Breaking the Mold, and...
Verbally Challenged.
Verbally Challenged. Shout out to Jose. And shout out to the rest of the Cool Table team. I mean, the Nerve Rage team. They're not up there anymore. I keep looking up there for them, but they're not up there anymore. But we have Manny behind the scenes. We have Raul on Instagram. Marilyn Phyllis here. Thank you for coming through.
So, yeah, thanks for the invite, man.
We have tons of shit coming for this Rise of Skywalker shit. Tons of shit. Like,
all right.
People are going to be here Thursday. We're going to record a ton of shit. People are going to be here Friday. It's going to be tons of content related to that film on Nerve Rage, on the Patreon, and on the channel. Shout out to Dante, who I thought was going to come through tonight. I'm a little disappointed.
He hit right as I walked in the door. He said he had to coach a class the last second.
Bummer. Yeah. But he will be here on Skywalker night.
Sweet.
Who else do we have?
Manny,
I shouted out. We have Andy and Gort.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And
You know, there's a app. Probably you have Notepad on your phone. You can,
like, yeah, I probably should. I probably should.
And the music from this episode is a link that's sent to Bobby right now to be uploaded.
Beautiful. And that'll do it.
With that, Flappy Labius.
Velvety Vagina.
Tasty Taint.
Tight Dick Player. That's how you do a fucking episode, boys.
How long was that? Did you guys start right at 7?
It was 4 hours long.
Still fucking going.
How long is it?